the Opie and Anthony Show.
We're back with the Opie and Anthony Show, the ONA virus spreading across America. We want to say hi to Chicago once again this morning. We're obsessed with Chicago.
Gotta be.
Big hi to everyone listening to us on WCKG. And we're still waiting for Robert Fetter to give us a call and stop hiding behind his column.
Yeah, he's the guy in the Chicago Sun-Times that trashed the show, saying it wasn't, we've been on there a month and a half, and he's saying, like, hey, it's not going to catch on. He's just a douche.
See, it's not happening, just like it wasn't happening for Rover. Like, the guy didn't even give us a chance yet. And he knows how this radio thing works. It's way too early. We know Chicago's going to be tough. We know. We know about radio history. Most shows that syndicate to Chicago don't do well. We understand that, but we do think we're going to find our audience in Chicago. And this guy's already saying, ah, see, nothing's happening.
After a month and a half, Jesus.
Well, you know what, Louis? Louis C.K. in studio, you guys can relate to this.
Yep.
These guys that talk out of their asses, they got a column and they just, you know, they make these massive, well, they just flat out lie is what they do.
And because they know the truth. Like, he's saying something that he knows, like, he's friends with Mancow, this guy, which is cool. That's his guy.
Rumor has he went to Mancow's wedding. I hear he was the flower girl, so.
Okay, that's funny.
That's right.
Ass.
We're not calling you a traipsing mo, of course. We're just joking, elbow to the ribs.
That's what I hear. I hear he was the flower girl at Mancow's wedding, because he had to add that in parentheses. Obviously, the solution is to hire Mancow. No, the solution is to at least give us a chance before you start with this crap.
How about a ratings book?
How about a ratings book,
Jesus,
right?
Give us one ratings book that's all ours.
Well, the ratings came out in Chicago, and we're doing nothing, but it's too early. This book wasn't ours, really.
We're on even a month of the 3 months.
I think we're on maybe a month. Maybe.
Maybe.
Maybe, if that.
Maybe.
So, you know, we're
in Chicago.
You were just in Chicago,
yeah,
Louis?
Last week.
So we're telling, you know, Robert, give us a call. We'll discuss this.
Yeah.
And he's still hiding.
And this faggot doesn't want to, doesn't want to answer his phone. And we get the pests on the on the job. And yesterday we wound up getting like all of his personal information and stuff. They are the worst.
5 minutes after we mentioned him, I walk over to the PalTalk screen. I look, and his social security number is up there,
and his phone, his home phone number, address, how much taxes he pays in his neighborhood.
Wow.
They are ruthless, and I love them.
Pictures of him as the flower girl. Right there.
Exactly.
For us to see, so.
Better than Homeland Security.
They are. They absolutely are.
Amazing. Come on, Robert. Let's go. Give us a call.
Yeah, just call up.
We've called you. We've left messages. No, you know how to get a hold of us.
Mancow's not even in Chicago.
No.
No, he got kicked off his hometown station.
Yeah, no, and I did all the radio, and none of it's, I mean, good.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
Hey, Eric and Kathy, come on. Eric and Kathy, come on.
I didn't even know what was going on.
Oh, if you have what we call the hole on the show, any show that includes what we like to call the hole, she is the fun wrecker of any radio show.
Right.
They have tried for years to get a hole on this program, and we finally compromised and got Jimmy Norton.
Because I admitted the homosexual experiences in my youth. This is as close to a chick as we're going to get.
As close as we're going to get. But she's the one, you know, you've seen it. How many shows have you done?
Oh,
Jesus Christ. And they're always, guys, now, oh, God, you don't have to be like that. Just the fun wreckers.
Yep.
Just put the big, I just picture like the train, an old style train going down the tracks, boop, boop, 90, 100 miles an hour, and then this big sweaty hand pulling the brake. That is what a hole's job is. Sparks flying out of the comedy wheels.
Come on, stop.
There it is. We got some clips of a hole.
Guys, I can't take this. I gotta say, you gotta stop.
Yeah, do we?
They're just there to, you know what they're there for, to balance it out and keep the lady.
Yeah, the program directors all think it's a good balance.
No, like women are listening just because somebody says that occasionally.
Yeah.
I like listening to that show that offends me as long as somebody occasionally stops it.
Yeah.
And just kind of curtails it and says, oh.
You know why? It's a lot like my house. I have my husband, and when his friends come over, I'm the one that goes, guys, coasters now.
Oh.
Take her out in the SS Peterson out to Modesto. Fix that problem.
I'm so sorry. I'm just trying to help, guys.
That's what radio's become.
That's our professional hole.
Hey, Louie, I was talking about Lucky Louie yesterday with Joel Hollander.
Who's that again?
He runs the radio division for CBS.
Oh,
a huge fan, and he's bummed that the show's off the air.
Well, maybe we should do it as a radio show.
He thought it was
old-time radio.
Yeah. The sound effects guy.
Honey, I'm home. Yeah, somebody with clunking coconut
abs. You have to do a horse if you're doing sound effects.
It's got to be the horse. Yeah, the coconuts. I don't know why a horse was involved in everything that's on the radio.
Yeah.
Look at here. A horse is coming, smoking a Lucky Strike cigarette and trampling some Negroes.
Clip-clop.
He said it was the new Honeymooners.
Oh, that's great. Yeah,
he said it was the new Honeymooners.
It's also the good guys in common that it's gone.
That was like a great compliment, though. That was like
awesome
a great compliment because nothing else was really tried like that, like the Honeymooners. The Honeymooners, brilliant writing. Mm-hmm. The acting was great. Fun cast.
Now, when I started putting the show together, I got the DVD for the Honeymooners, and I watched the first one. I wanted to see how they hit the air. Same with All the Family. Both shows hit the air like gangbusters. Like, I wanted to see if they eased in or
what was the first Honeymooners episode?
The first Honeymooners episode is unbelievably classic. It starts with the wife, with Alice, and she Trixie just got upstairs, just got a new TV.
Oh, the TV. Okay.
And Alice has never even had a TV. And so, because Ralph is cheap. Mm-hmm. That was the first joke, because Ralph is cheap. So Trixie says, give him the old pipe and slippers routine. Make him feel good. So Ralph comes home, and she says, hi, dear. This is the first time you've seen them as a couple together. She just says, hi, dear. Welcome home. And he goes, what's your problem?
He's already on
what to
us.
What do you want something? And they start screaming at each other.
Aha!
But, yeah, every couple had, you know, on TV thus far had been sweet to each other.
Yeah.
And they're the first ones. And you hear the audience explode when he, like, they go, oh, my God, this is a real couple, where people don't say I love you when they walk in the door.
Just screaming at each other.
Oh.
I want to watch Liberace.
Yeah.
What is that?
That was when she wanted the TV.
She wanted
screaming
to watch Liberace.
Yeah. I loved one of the lines in one of them was like, I got an atomic kitchen. This place looks like Yucca Flats after the blast.
Yeah, yes.
Always just bashing him, his lack of income, the crap hole they lived in.
And then the mother comes over and demeans him, fighting for them. It's awful, and he's poor.
Oh.
He's like if he was rich and they were doing that, but it's so brutal.
Yeah.
It was great. So
I didn't know that was the first show, though.
I don't want
TV.
I don't want my salary to leak out. And she goes, your salary couldn't drip out. Could be the greatest broke line ever.
Say to a bus driver.
Yeah,
look, he's not trying.
And that
so mean.
That was the great similarity between your show and the Honeymooners was that it the wife wasn't just being bitched at by the husband.
Right.
She, like, on a lot of the instances, got the upper hand on Ralph.
Yes.
And Ralph just had to be this schmo that took it.
Exactly.
And that's exactly what you were doing on the show, you know?
Oh, exactly.
The wife is smarter,
gets
over on you more. You're trying to pull something over on her, and she's 20 steps ahead of you.
Well, and also, she's working. Like, it's a common American couple situation now is that guys don't have the pride. They have too much pride to go get a job that they don't like.
Mm-hmm.
They think it's beneath them to do something that they don't want to do for money. And women are like, thank God I have the opportunity to do a job and provide. So like, women don't have that kind of pride, so they're better. And guys are like, I'm not doing that. And she's like, let me at it.
They want to work.
A piece of shit like you.
And the relationship with the kid, it would crack me up. The lack of real communication between the father and daughter is hysterical. But it's got to be. You can't talk baby talk. And you watch some of these shows, and the father is so involved in everything the small child is saying. And you're just like, I don't understand this.
No.
This is babble. Kids are stupid.
Yeah, and also,
they're dumb.
They don't talk baby talk either. They're just rotten little people. They're not cute. They just suck.
They're ridiculously stupid.
I looked into the cellar last night, and Louis was on stage, and I didn't even know you were going to be there. And he's doing some bit about his kid falling and hitting her head. And all I knew was I watched for a second, and the thing is, like, you said something how you get used to it.
Yeah.
And then you think, like, oh, she's dead. All right. It was like my kid's dead joke, and it was just so...
Well, because your kid, you know, when you have a baby, you know, we're on our second one, so even more, they hit the deck occasionally. They'll hit their head, hits pavement, and it's that sound of, like, it sounds like a rock inside of a peach, like, hitting...
Oh, God.
Like, it's just, all you hear tissue, like, getting destroyed.
Yeah.
And the first couple of times, you're like, it's like your whole body quakes with fear. But it happens, like, 100 times. After a while, you're like, Well, it's probably dead.
You don't. Well, you can't keep reacting like that. Just after a while, you just get immune to it. No, because my one daughter pulled the other kid down by the grabbed her by the throat, grabbed her baby. This is a 4-year-old.
Oh,
grabs her
man.
Baby sister by the throat, pulls her to the pavement, and then says, "I was trying to help her."
Yeah, a lie comes out.
Yeah, immediately. But
she's
while she's
cop.
Doing it. Yeah. She's got shitty timing, though. Like, she's pulling her down and saying it at the same time. She's like, "I'm trying to help her." And so then she looks at me kind of with this wild grin of, like, I might have killed my sister, and I think I feel good. And I'm looking at her like, "You suck." And then the baby stood up and said, "I'm sorry."
Oh, Jesus.
Isn't that sad?
That is so sad.
She apologized to us that she almost got killed. She's like, so we realized that my daughter and I both laughed at her.
I guess the more kids you have, I don't know. I don't have any. I don't want any. But my girlfriend's sister has 3 kids now. The first one, I remember, anywhere they went, she went with disinfectant wipes and set up everything and wiped it down and just looked at contempt with the waitresses who would be like carrying coffee pots too close to the baby and things like that. And by the third one, that just goes out the window. It's like they're just picking up toys from out in the street and putting it in their mouths.
You don't care. No, like the woman on TV and the Lysol. I saw the Lysol commercial where she has a ball and she's just dousing it with Lysol till it's dripping and then hands it to a kid.
There you go.
By the way, what a real comic I am. I say to Louis, like, and I give away his punchline. I didn't mean to do it. Like,
no,
hey,
you
what
know,
about
but
that joke where the two Jews walk into the bar and they own it? What about that one?
So much for that joke. Louis's got to go write something.
What a housewife. That's how housewives do it with comedy.
Hey, let's go to Mike and Yonkers. He's challenging you guys on the honeymooners thing. Mike, what's up?
Hey, good morning, guys.
Good morning, Mike.
Morning. Whoever's saying that that's the first episode for the honeymooners, it's definitely not the first episode.
Oh,
lost episode.
Oh, we're not talking about the lost
one. Screw the lost episode.
The lost ones
are
like,
why they're lost.
And some of those were like sketches that were done on
Cavalcade and
no, of course, but it's much
Jackie Gleason show.
Listen, the thing was, it's more interesting when I tell the story here to say it was the first one.
Right.
I know I'm fudging it, but who cares?
Yeah,
everybody
cares?
Who was alive then is dead. Thank God.
Jackass.
And we got a good laugh out of it. That's all we care about.
It doesn't matter. Sure. Thanks for splitting.
Craig on Long Island. Craig.
Hey, what's up, gentlemen?
Hey.
Hey.
You guys are missing the best Alice dig ever.
What?
He comes home and he says,
so mad.
"I'm the king, Alice. I'm the king and you're nothing." And she says, "That's right, Ralph. You're the king of nothing." Later.
That show still holds up, obviously.
Totally. And
I've
my favorite episode,
over.
He finds a suitcase of money.
In
the bus. It turns out to be counterfeit, but he spends all of it.
Yeah.
So now he's in the hole how much he spent.
Yeah. Easy
Alice,
come, easy
that's the best
go.
Part. She calls him on it. And he takes him 4 seconds to process it.
Yeah.
Go through shame and regret, but right to, no, man.
Anger.
That's right. I spent it. That's me,
that's
baby.
Right. I had it. And I went with it.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Is that the with the clothes in it? Where he's like, she's like, "Well, you can't return those clothes unless the man knows some elephants that need to work."
That's right.
She was just a vicious, awful, dominating bitch.
Talking about how fat he was,
Really well, too.
Let's go to Jason the trucker. Jason.
Hey, Louis C.K., the funniest part I thought is when I seen told your wife that your daughter was an asshole, and the next time I told my 3-year-old he was an asshole to his face, I thought it was the funniest fucking
That probably got dumped out of, so Louie inspired this man to tell his child to her face that she was an a-hole.
Yeah, that's nice. That's what he got from the show.
Nice. My daughter, she wouldn't know what that meant. It wouldn't matter if I said that to her.
Then they just start using it around the school and their friends.
Yeah, my little, the 15-month-old said, "You got to be careful." Like my wife, we went for Christmas to her parents' place, and there's somebody whoever's listening is going to know the story. All right, she called somebody privately. You know how when you're at Christmas holidays, you're all having a great time.
Yeah.
But then when you go in the separate rooms, you just say horrible things about everybody you just hugged and kissed. So she said, "What a C word about this this woman. And then the little baby is walking around.
What a C-word. No.
What a C-word. Was just singing it for the rest of the vacation.
How adorable. Little sing-songy.
Yeah. Really nice.
That'd be a great kids video with the little red ball bouncing over the same word.
Let's go to Dave in Maine. Dave. Dave, we're hanging with Louis C.K. What's up?
Come on in, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
What's up, Dave?
Callers are a little bit...
spit it out, faggot.
We're a little slow.
Dave, well, he wants to know what was it like working with Jim on Lucky Louis there?
Jim is hilarious because he works so hard. He wants so badly for it to be good.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you know, he seems like a careless... jerk.
Cutie.
Like, yeah, cutie.
Sure.
Comes off like just like he's just going to come in and piss all over the place.
Yeah.
And you kind of figure when you work with comics, you're going to have to rein them in and they're going to go, can't I just say it different every time? Like, comedians are usually idiots on a set.
Yeah, I'm just going to riff.
Yeah.
But
he would very
down.
Respectfully be like, excuse me, may I try saying, blow your, dad or something like that. Like, he would, like, very respectfully ask to say awful, disgusting things in the next take. But he worked for this acting coach, Bob Krakauer, every day, and he was... No, very sincere and very hardworking guy. And I thought he was great on the show. I liked it.
Yeah.
I thought his character was hilarious.
Krakauer did a great job, but after seeing my performance, I should have worked with Copperfield or somebody else who could have really done like bug eyes.
Yeah, but it's funny. It's good. It was old-fashioned TV acting. I thought it was great.
Yeah. Old-fashioned TV acting.
So that's what I think it was.
I think that was a compliment.
I don't like the new realist kind of like mumbling jerks on TV. They're not funny. Who wants to watch that?
Like the old school.
Yeah.
Mr. Faversham.
Yeah, exactly. That's awesome.
Let's stop right there for a second. We got to take a break. All right.
Right.
Okay, in the house. We promoting anything, Louis?
I'm at the Trump Marina on Saturday night.
Very nice.
In Atlantic City. TrumpMarina.com.
That's right.
Saturday night.
And you got a fan in Charlotte because they're like, plug Louis C.K. Charlotte performance.
That's right. And next weekend I'm in Charlotte at
Comedy
Zone. The Comedy Zone.
Okay. But this weekend.
This weekend, Saturday night.
Trump Marina.
Trump Marina. All right. We continue with Louis C.K. and we got Otto and George and Nina's here.
Nina Harley. We didn't know she was coming in or not. No one got a confirmation, but
Jimmy did a sex scene with Nina.
Really?
Well,
you had sex with her?
Not sex, but it was.
We'll get into it after the break.
In a sex scene,
kind of.
And if we don't talk about this story, we're just stupid.
Two guys with the
thing,
the bathroom,
the thing at the bowling alley.
Yeah,
it's a horrific story. But then you got the other story.
What?
About the woman in New Orleans.
Ah, it's another one.
We got to decide which one is more
of a
red
story. One's a love story. Well, they could both be love stories, actually.
Yeah, we'll get into that after the break. Huh?
Is that the one that you talk about? Is the guy, like, something wrong with the guy?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah. It's not a vegetable, Jimmy.
That should be addressed.
This guy wished it was a vegetable. We'll talk about that next. It's the ONA virus spreading across America.
The Opie and Anthony Fatty Pig Fatty Contest began like a stampede of hungry rhinos. But now it more closely resembles a sleepy, winded elephant. The current heavyweight in the Fatty Pig Fatty Contest is Crystal from Cleveland, who weighed in at 430 pounds. We're so sure there's someone bigger out there, we put up a fatty finder's fee in the amount of $1,000 to the person who brings in the heaviest girl by the end of the contest. So grab your sonar equipment and find us a whale. Remember, the heaviest girl at the end of the Fatty Pig Fatty Contest gets $10 for every floorboard-shattering, tear-inducing, self-esteem-destroying pound on her body. Go to opieandanthony.com for contest details.
Sponsored by H57 Hoodia.
Hear what everyone else is talking about. ONA Uncut and Live, continuing the show on XM Satellite Radio starting at 9 a.m. Eastern. Visit xmradio.com to subscribe.
It's the Opie and Anthony Show.
That's right, it is the Opie and Anthony Show. We got a full house today. Louis C.K., doing great for us, and now we got to say hi to Otto and George as well.
Hi, good morning. Hi.
We had Bob Saget call in, and now I'm hearing Jerry Springer's going to call in, by the way, Anthony. He's still on Dancing with Stars, or Dancing with the Stars, or whatever the hell the show's called. None of us even watch it, but we're obsessed with making sure he continues on the show.
Yeah, the goof factor.
He said if he wins, he's going to dedicate it to the Opie and Anthony Show. If he wins, he will say that on the air.
Yeah, in case you don't know what's going on, we had an interview with Jerry Springer about 3 weeks ago, and he was on this show, and we told him that our pass the ONA Pest will vote for him now every week. And he begged us. He said, guys, please do not do this. My knees hurt. I went on as just to have a little fun and maybe get some exposure. You know, he knew that he was the goof factor.
That's awesome.
All these shows have the goof factor, someone that obviously can't skate or dance. And Jerry Springer was that guy. And he goes, please, guys, don't. I want to just go home at this point. That was 3 weeks ago.
But we think he was just being humble. If he does win, if he does win and doesn't dedicate it to the Opie and Anthony show, the same pests that made him win, oh, my God, they will never let him live it down.
Here's a radio segue. Speaking of can't skate, can't dance, what's going on with Paul McCartney and Heather Mills?
Yeah, we'll move on to that in 1 second. But from Dancing with the Stars last night, this is what happened, okay, with Jerry Springer.
Joey and Editor. Jerry and Kim.
So it was up to these two pairs, obviously, who was going to get voted off the show. Okay?
On our sixth week of competition, the couple with the lowest score, and therefore leaving right now.
All right.
Neither
the drama.
Of you.
Who?
None of you.
And here's why. In light of the early departure of Sarah and Tony and two couples leaving the competition last week, we've considered all the options. We think it's most fair that everyone move on to the next round.
Know what I'm thinking?
What?
Jerry got more votes to stay, but they didn't want to kick off that other couple.
It would have been too
so they used an excuse because someone else had to leave the show because her nanny's banging her husband.
That's scandalous.
That scandalous thing that's going on.
Why would you have to leave the show for that?
Yeah.
The Anthony, you banging. Watch too much television. Open the door and go for a walk. There's a world out there, you creep.
I can't help it.
And then just a little more audio, then we'll move on.
The judges' score for this week will be added to the judges' scores for next week. The viewer votes for this week will be added to the viewer votes for next week. We'll then combine the totals in our normal manner at the very end of next week's show, and then the couple with the lowest overall total will be eliminated.
Kind of rocket science.
Made and every point given by the judges last night will count. Our couples are being judged on their performances over two shows. Joey and Edita and Jerry and Kim have some serious work to do if they're going to pull themselves out of the bottom two next week, Jerry.
Yeah, Jerry was just annoyed. He's like, just pull it. Here, someone who saw the show, actually. Rodney in Texas, go ahead.
Hey, guys. Hey, I tell you what, I am pissed off with you guys. Y'all got me hooked on that goddamn show. I mean, dang show, my fault. But the agony in his eyes.
Yeah, everyone's saying the agony
so
in his
great
eyes.
Nobody wins except for you guys.
Yeah.
If he wins, he hates you. America hates you. The viewers hate you.
He's up there on that stage. And
we
he,
just win.
The greatest thing in the world.
He's on that stage knowing what's going on.
Yeah.
And he's like, he's rolling his eyes in agony last night, like, no, guys, stop.
You got to make him win it. You got to make him win it because then the whole point of the entire show is you guys.
Right.
You know, there's no
it's
other.
It's all about us.
We just
and
ruined
the pest.
Everything.
Awesome. We're trying, but the judges' votes count for something as well. So
the judges' votes count for 50%, and then the listener vote counts for 50%.
Yeah.
So our listeners have been pounding it to override the judges. We get calls and emails from listeners that are like, I've voted, you know, 10 times, voted 20 times. They only allow you to vote 10 times.
You got to use that power other ways. Like,
yeah.
Like local
for
races.
Good.
So little small towns have your guys move there and like
yeah.
Jerk is the alderman and
just win elections. And
yeah. Well,
sort of take over the whole country maybe.
Just
in time.
Little ways.
Well, the ONA Pest, they're getting the job done. They're voting every week for Jerry Springer. ABC.com. Help us out. Join the fight. Make Jerry win the whole thing. he hates us.
Old wobbly-kneed bastard.
All right, and we'll go to the Heather Mills now. Yes. There, Jimmy.
Heather Mills hit Sir Paul McCartney with the worst accusations yet.
Jerry Pinacoli has the breaking couples news.
Paul McCartney shooting down domestic abuse allegations. Today, the Beatles legend fires back on Extra over the explosive new claims from his estranged wife, Heather Mills. In 13 pages of court papers, Heather alleges Paul stabbed her in the arm with a broken wine glass, shoved her when she was pregnant, and grabbed her around the throat. In a statement issued through his lawyers, Paul says he wants to protect his children and not comment publicly, but that in court, quote, our client will be defending these allegations vigorously. justly and appropriately. A source close to Paul today accuses Heather of leaking the court papers to hurt Paul's reputation.
No more Michelle Nidell.
You know, when they always say that thing where he shoved her when she was pregnant,
yeah,
you're pregnant for 9 months. What, you're supposed to not shove somebody for 9 months? It's like almost a year you're supposed to, like, oh, hands off the beauty queen while she's got a baby in her.
Oh, the last trimester is the most important.
Yeah, it could have been real early on. Yeah. She pissed him off.
Yeah,
a little push.
Right after she took the test and he shoved her.
Shoved me.
Why didn't you put ice cream in?
Who else wants to believe that this is true?
Oh,
who else wants to believe that he's just a maniac
behind closed doors? I'm totally buying it.
You're buying it?
Yeah, yeah. I have to. Just to hear one of his love songs. Let me hear a love song. And just picture him just slapping her around.
Like, I love you with a wine glass.
Yeah.
You whore.
Bring me a wine glass. You one-legged bitch.
She was on Larry King years ago, and she was saying that she didn't know who Paul McCartney was, and she fell in love with him just as a guy.
Oh, sure.
It's like, come on.
A liar.
He's a Beatle.
He's also so good-looking. He's, you know, old.
He looks like an older woman now.
He does.
Definitely.
He's like 65, and he has hair like Christy McNichol in 1978. You can't be attracted
family.
To him.
Yeah.
I guess, but every time that anybody does, whenever they do court papers publicly, it's always awful.
Like, oh, yeah.
It's never like, you know, he told a boring story and so I'm divorcing him.
Yeah, it's all the awful stuff. Yeah, no one's going to remember that. One night, she sat there and just talked about a new rug.
Yeah. No, it's almost like you hear the lawyer saying to her, well, you can say stuff like shoved you when you were pregnant, stabbed you with a wine glass.
It's like this probably,
and she's like, yeah.
They do. They kind of coach the girls, too.
They probably hand you a menu.
Of course, just circle, circle what you want. Like your
wine glass is worth like $50,000.
Yes. Like you're ordering fireworks back in the day.
Circle an appetizer, an entree, and a dessert.
I'll take a wine glass to start, and then I'd like a no stump operation for dessert.
That's the best.
Yeah, what was the stump operation again?
She wanted to get an operation on her stump, and my new idol said no because it will interfere with my vacation plan.
Yeah.
Why is she getting her stump? Isn't that a hopeless cause?
I know.
Her stump operated
Unless they're putting
on?
A grafting a lizard tail onto it and have that thing grow.
I want to get a bottle opener on my stump.
Yeah, what could they possibly do?
The improvement.
Anything the they do is just going to make
get
it shorter.
Help my stump.
I know. You're not getting an operation on your stump.
On your stump?
Your stump.
I gotta go to Maui. You can't get you.
Well, Heather's friend speaks out here.
Oh, no.
Today, in an extra exclusive, Heather's friend and American publicist Michelle Elizabeth reacts to the accusation.
She did not leak anything, and she wouldn't. Otherwise, she would have come to me.
So, we had to ask, if this alleged abusive behavior was going on, why did Heather stay?
All you need is love. That's what she thought.
Wow.
Quotes.
All you need is love.
He goes, used my stump to roll over some pizza dough. I don't even like pizza.
They're all in Europe. Who cares?
Yeah. Oh, God.
Married to a Beatle. She hit the lotto anyway.
Of course she did. Yep.
That's it. No prenup, right?
He's as dumb as they come. Not
no, prenup.
No prenup. And he had a kid with her.
Oof. Yeah, see.
Her kids should just kill him. I mean, his kids should kill him because that's the thing her
insurance. Well, his older kids hated Heather Mills from the beginning.
They're probably older than she is. They're probably older than she is.
Trying to sleep in here and clunk at night as she gets up for a midnight snack.
Parrots flying all over the place.
Terrible.
Every morning.
Hear Lady Pecker going off on her leg.
You want to hear Lady McCartney real fast?
Oh, yeah.
Sure.
This is Brother Joe.
Maybe not.
Or not. E-Rock.
Fix it or you're
fine. What did you do? Run. Run and fix it.
Yeah, something's going on. We'll try.
Incompetent. There it is.
It's just going on way too long.
All right, George, relax.
What is that, Alan Sherman? The guy sucks. Got Nina Hartley backstage. She's got a book to promote about her days in pornography called Oh, My Aching Cunt.
Jesus.
George is surly. Why are you so surly, George?
It's song going on way too long.
That is the medical term, stump, right? There's not like some nice...
There should be a nicer word.
It's like, what's her name, Pamela, who plays my wife on the show, who's actually very funny. She was talking about how medical advances, they can, like, take the retina of an eagle and transplant it to another eagle.
Really?
But for, like, a walker, they still, the cut-open tennis balls, all they got.
Like, that's still the best.
Because it's not
you
important
see those every day, yeah. It's
just even not a rich,
enough.
Like, a millionaire's got his cut-open
with the tennis balls.
Ball. On the end of the walker.
And what is that? Yeah, is there a medical terminology for the tennis ball?
Nobody cares after a while.
No.
About old people.
I've seen the old folks, though, that really have the fancy ones with the handbrakes on them and everything.
But they still got the tennis
balls. Wheels and the tennis
balls. Still got the tennis balls. Hey, we were going to move on, but Danny brought to my attention that this next clip about Heather Mills and Paul McCartney is really good.
All right. Danny's putting himself out there.
Well, he's claiming something else. Listen to this.
Well, Paul McCartney once wrote a song, P.S. I Love You. Mr. McCartney could pen a follow-up, P.S. I Didn't Beat You. Heather and Paul.
Why?
That was
unfathomable.
Wow.
At number two, Heather is now publicly accusing her soon-to-be former husband of abuse. The London Evening Standard published information they claim was leaked from the Mills-McCartney divorce papers, which include these shocking claims.
Here we go. Heather. Listen to this.
Paul beat her. He stabbed her with a broken wine bottle during one of the attacks. Paul is an alcoholic and a heavy drug user. And even that Paul tried to stop her from breastfeeding their daughter, telling her, quote, they are my breasts. Imagine as quickly retaliated via his lawyer, saying, quote, he recognizes that the only correct form for his response is in the current divorce proceedings. Our client will be defending these allegations vigorously and appropriately. Mills Pete say the court documents are highly confidential and refuse to confirm if the leaked info is genuine.
All right.
Didn't deny it, though.
How do you not deny that?
Just get out and say, look, whatever this, whoever leaked this, whatever, is not true.
Yeah.
There you go.
The moment you listen, did you stab her with a wine glass?
Well, you know,
this is all going to come out in court.
Can you define stab?
I'd rather have this come out in court in sealed documents where no one will ever hear the truth than me saying no here in the public forum where it's going to make every news story.
Yeah, where it's the only place that actually matters.
Yeah, that only matters in the public eye.
He didn't deny the claim or anything?
No, no. No denial of anything.
Maybe he figures by not even commenting on it, it's so absurd, you know.
Sometimes that works, but not in this case. Yeah. In this case, he should just...
Well, wouldn't she get a pile of money without accusing him of anything just by being married to him? I mean, maybe there's some truth.
He already offered...
more money.
A pretty nice payday.
Now you get more money.
How much could he lose, really, if it's all true? Like, how much could he really lose? Like, $10 million out of...
More than that. Way more than that.
Way more.
Probably
it's still splitting millions.
At least $100 million. Yeah, at least $100 million.
She has a kid now.
It would be great if he just went, that's right, I did. She's a cunt.
Did it all. What do you want from me?
Spend 5 minutes with her, you'd stab her with it. Have you gotten your hand, mate?
Mate.
God.
Sorry for saying that word.
Sorry, there's a guy around the corner there that has a button.
Takes care of that.
And,
don't worry about it.
Hopefully. Right. Although, when we got fired last time, the same guy that's on the button now was on the button.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, the guy that was supposed to save us that day.
Yes, CBS.
It's like hiring John Carr to babysit your daughter.
Put her in a little cowboy hat and some six guns.
They say he's grown up, though, so hopefully he has.
Everything's fine.
Hopefully he has.
Management now.
Well, we're waiting.
You know, it's another great James Caan movie, speaking of Freebie and the Bean, The Gambler. Did you ever see that one?
Oh, that's a great one.
Yeah, awesome movie, yeah. He's just a sick, degenerate gambler in it. It's really cool. Paul Sorvino's also in it.
Oh, right. He keeps like making more and more dangerous bets and losing.
Yeah.
And then finally he just gets a black hooker and starts a fight with her pimp.
Yeah.
It turns out, like, cause obviously he's got nothing to do with gambling.
He can't gamble any more money, so he gambles with his life.
And he slaps a dangerous pimp.
Yeah, Huggy Bear.
Huggy Bear, of course he did.
Yeah, of course.
What else is he going to play the president in a movie?
I got to check that movie out. All right, we're waiting to see what we can do with that other story. That might have to wait till we get over to XM, which is fine with us.
I like that story.
We do like that one. We could go with this. The New Orleans story is really good, too.
All right.
Listen to this. One of the big stories today.
He wanted to listen to jazz music on North Rampart last night. Instead, musician John Gross sat outside of King Bolden's bar, shocked.
Yeah, that's beyond anything that I've directly experienced before.
Just a few doors down.
I mean, she is dismembered.
Police find a woman murdered in this apartment thanks to a tip from her killer. Her body in pieces. Police say the man who did this jumped to his death right after from the rooftop bar of the Omni Royal Hotel last night. But the scene at the Omni Royal Hotel was just the beginning of a long night for police. When they checked inside of the suicide victim's pockets, they found a 5-page suicide note leading them to an apartment complex on the 800 block of North Rampart.
When the detectives went in the apartment, they found a dead white female that had been dismembered.
Sources close to the investigation tell Eyewitness News they found her legs inside of the oven, her head in a pot on the stove, and the rest of her body in a trash bag. Police say her boyfriend even left her family's contact information for the police before he left for the Omni Royal.
It appears he cleaned it up a lot before he left.
Police say he planned the whole thing.
I would imagine that he was in some serious mental anguish and pain.
Can you imagine?
I couldn't fathom to think what caused him to do it.
Good call.
But he had to be in some serious pain to do it.
Lucy Bustamante, Channel 4, Eyewitness News.
Did he at least put a mint on the pillow?
What else? It'd be really funny if they say, what was your reason? He's like, I loved it, but honest to God, I was just hungry.
Sorry, my mind. Not to do that. I forgot.
Were they married? Cool.
Every place was closed that I called for takeout.
I saw those legs.
They weren't married. They'd hooked up. They were actually featured in a story during Katrina that they weren't going to evacuate, so they stayed there. And the news did a whole story on them. They're out in front of this place cooking beans on some open fire.
Oh, that.
Coincidence. And then
five-page suicide note.
Yeah,
it's a little long.
Five pages.
You don't want to write a suicide note where people are going da da da. What else?
All right, yada yada.
You don't like life.
You don't want people to start skimming on your suicide
then
note.
Goes on about that.
Desperation couldn't get a job.
Katrina.
Couldn't help myself. Blah blah blah.
A tasty bitch. Blah blah blah. Yeah. So he they did a feature on them, and he dismembered her, and then the legs were in a pan in the oven and turned on, and so they were burnt.
I hate to interrupt you.
Yes.
But on the phone.
Oh.
Hold that thought. On the
phone.
Speaking
of the lady that was
burnt legs.
Right. We have the legs. No, it's Jerry Springer.
Oh, there you go.
Wow. Jerry.
Hey, guys.
Hi, Jerry Springer. There he is.
Jerry, you know that
you're
we know.
Still on. You're the reason I'm still on.
I told you guys.
All of our listeners are just pounding the phone lines and voting for Jerry Springer.
That's right.
This is not good for America.
Look, we have video of you. This is perfect timing. They're showing you on Good Morning America falling to the floor going, what is going on? But Jerry knows what's going on, right, Jerry?
Well, I suspected that might happen, what happened last night. But when we were finally under the spotlight and they do the drum roll and, you know, one of the two couples are going home, then I thought, you know what? I'm wrong, and they'll probably do something like this next week or the week after. I really thought I was going home then.
Yeah, you did, huh? Sorry, Jerry. You are not going home.
Until we decide.
Yeah.
Let me make a case to you, okay?
All right.
See, this is what happened 3 weeks ago. He begged us, like, don't do this to me. Go ahead, Jerry. The floor is yours.
Yeah, well, it's enough.
He's had it.
I love that that's the case. Just
no, it's, you know, I mean, it's fun, but it really isn't fair.
Don't fight anymore. It's a free country.
Great dancers.
It's not fair for the other dancers. We know,
really,
Jerry.
They're really good.
We don't care.
That's
the thing is that when unfair things happen to dancers, it doesn't matter.
Exactly. You know what our listeners are hearing right now, right? Vote for Jerry. Yeah. Vote for Jerry.
And,
vote for Jerry.
And all they love watching you dance.
Yeah, and next week I have to do what? The mambo and the foxtrot?
Is it the foxtrot? By the way, you looked stunning in your matador outfit.
Yeah. Well, you did. Honestly, guys, when was the last time you did a mambo?
I can't say. The mambo.
Yeah. Mambo.
Mambo. Carlos.
Tuna fish. What am I, a cat or something?
My grandmother didn't do this. So, Jerry, how are the knees holding up?
They actually do hurt, particularly the left knee. I mean, they got it really taped up, and it's absurd, you know. You know, what do they say? You know, and Emmitt Smith, God love him. He's an athlete. I mean, at least there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
As cool as you can be.
How embarrassed are you every week when the crowd starts booing because you're not getting voted off?
Yeah, that's got to hurt. Wow.
And it's not my idea.
Now, the judges always give you very, very bad scores.
Yeah, but they're always very nice.
Yeah, they're very nice.
They're
but
really nice, and then they always give me the lowest score, which means they at least have integrity.
Right.
Yeah, so, but they really give you the lowest scores, and they really do not want you on the show.
Yeah.
Why don't can't you quit? Can't you just say, I don't want to do this anymore, or you just don't have it up?
Well, he has a dance party he has to think of.
Yeah, because right. as soon as I lose, they put her on a boat back to Australia.
Wow.
Jerry, are they on to us yet?
Boat.
You what?
Are they on to us yet?
Are they who?
Are they on to us? Are they on to us?
Yeah, has anyone said anything like, hey, is this voting rigged or something?
Oh, yeah. No. They're real careful about that with the FCC and everything. No, that actually is, no, it's accurate. I mean, they don't mess with that.
Well, we don't doubt it's accurate.
So that means we have a chance to make you win this whole thing still, right?
If people keep voting, I guess it is possible. I mean, but it's absurd.
This is the guy that runs the Jerry Springer show saying this is absurd.
Oswald on Instant Feedback, I voted for Jerry almost 500 times the other night.
This is great. This is wonderful.
They shoot horses, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just like that.
Yeah. Well, there's just no excuse for this. But, I'm trying. It's just, yeah, everyone thinks I threw it two nights ago. I wasn't trying to lose. That was, you know, that's what it, yeah, and then they say, oh, you weren't trying. That was my best effort.
Your best effort has people thinking you're trying to throw the fight.
Yeah, what does that say? Talk about self-esteem, Cecil.
Now, your partner is very good.
She's phenomenal. She really is. She is.
And I guess people are assuming that's what's getting you through.
Well, of course. No, I think it's my my back step that does it. She's getting me through. She's great.
Yeah.
By the way, Jerry, no deals. We're going to see how far we can take this.
Yeah, we are pushing you into the winner's circle, my friend.
Yeah, oh, this is great. I'm going to make you a partner in my new line of dance studios.
Hey, do you get to talk? If you get kicked off, either way, do you get to talk?
Yes.
Okay, so no matter what, you get to say something?
I was working on my speech last night. And it's a good one. You're really going to like it.
Does it have the words Opie and Anthony show in it?
Yeah.
It certainly should.
Yeah, I'll be...
You continue to dance for our pleasure, Jerry.
That's right.
Yes.
Dance.
We make you dance.
I am not worthy. Opie Anthony, I'm not worthy.
We're like Charlie Sheen, and you're like that Vietnamese guy with the big teeth, and we're just shooting at your feet.
Dance!
Yeah. It's like the guy in the old cowboy movies, you know.
Yeah.
The pistol, yeah.
Just like, pow, pow, what was that movie?
Yeah.
It's Spider.
Shane.
Yeah.
You got to go to
Shane.
Shane. You got to go to abc.com. The message boards is just filled with comments from the One A Pest.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. And they're voting like crazy.
They love you, Jerry. They're going to be voting for you. And I apologize for that, but there really is no other way this can go.
No.
That's right. Okay. This will be good for America.
Yes.
Yeah, of course it is.
And you think the culture's falling apart.
Now, where are you off to do your regular show?
Yeah, now I'm in a few minutes flying back to Chicago. So
Chicago to do the show. What do you got lined up? How many shows you do in one day?
While this is going on, I do three shows a day.
Three shows a day. So you got to deal with three shows worth of those mutants.
Another reason why he wants off the show, because it's killing him. He has to fly to Chicago, do his show, and then he goes flying back to, where is it, L.A., I guess?
Yeah.
You fly commercial or private?
Private. I have my own plane.
Oh, look at you.
Look at me. Yeah, well, if you were a dancer, you'd have one, too.
Jeez. You're a pilot or...
No.
Fly yourself?
Myself up there, no.
Like to see his rudder kneecap go out and spin in.
And we got another guy, Mel from Connecticut. I auto dialed 4,800 times.
4,800, folks.
Jerry, you're going to continue to dance.
Okay.
All right,
you,
Mr. Springer.
Be there at the ceremony, okay?
I would love
it. Great. Hey, thanks a lot.
Have a safe flight.
Thank you, Jerry. Have fun, man.
See? Bye-bye. Bye, sweetie.
Just in case you guys thought we were making this up,
we're completely
controlling Dancing with the Stars with Jerry Springer.
That's awesome.
It's getting tougher and tougher as the weeks go on.
I just love how miserable he is that this is working. That, like, he didn't want it right from the start.
No, that was
it. Wasn't like,
ago.
Hey guys, make sure you vote for me. He was going, I want off this show. And that's the only reason we were saying, guys, vote for this guy.
Yeah.
We want to make his life miserable.
It's going to be tough. So, ONA pass. Let's see what we can get done, okay? Vote for Jerry, ABC.com.
Yep.
More with Louis C.K. and Otto and George. Otto, where are you going to be? Comics? COMX?
Yeah, Comics tonight with Nina Hartley and, it's like a brand new club. It's supposed to be like a
$10 million
club.
It's on 14th Street. It's like it's in the Meatpacking District. It's actually run by the same people who run this other club in Denver. It's supposed to be a very great place.
All right. We'll talk more with Otto and George and Louis C.K. playing the Trump Marina.
That's
right. Saturday night.
Okay. It's the ONA virus spreading across America.
I can walk on my hands.
I can fart and chew gum.
I play the oboe.
I can ride a unicycle.
I wear a bra and lace panties.
So your talent is being queer, Travis?
It's the Opie and Anthony Walkover Talent Show. If you have a unique skill, talent, music group, or physical affliction, we want to exploit.
You can email Steve at foundrymusic.com with your ideas, or you can just show up during the walk to XM and start shucking and jiving.
Shucking and jiving? Jesus, Danny.
I don't write this
It's the Obi and Anthony Show.
We never stopped doing the show, but we had to get the commercials in. The Obi and Anthony Show, the ONA virus spreading across America. Louis C.K. in studio, playing the Trump Marina Saturday night.
And Otto and George, the great Otto and George, with Nina Hartley, actually, at Comics tonight on 14th Street in the Meatpacking District. It's a very hot new comedy club here in New York City.
Yeah.
And how can they get tickets? Do you know, Otto?
212-524-2500. Secret agent man.
I have one thing I have to mention. New Year's Eve, I'm doing the Borgata in Atlantic City. Tickets go on sale Saturday morning at Ticketmaster if you want to go.
I can't.
And Roland
wait.
Had something to tell people very briefly.
Oh, boy. Roland.
I forget. It was just something he mentioned to me that I couldn't quite grab.
Yeah.
It was about my Hammerstein show?
Yesterday, a guy called Ed Norton wants to come see Jimmy at Hammerstein.
Oh, November 10th.
I won't accept this as fact.
No, this is a lie.
No,
this is a lie.
These two are in cahoots together.
No. I can't stand this.
Edward,
he's excited to see him. He hasn't seen him live before.
Yeah, Edward needed 4 tickets. I wasn't sure that Roland said that. So I wasn't trying to say anything. I just sure that he wanted to.
You don't know how it annoys me that an actor like Edward Norton, who I think is a really good actor.
Oh, Edward Norton.
The actor, is a fan of this little nothing.
Oh, cut it out. He just wanted to come to see some comedy. I just 4 tickets. I just wasn't sure what you said. I'm not going to do anything.
You stink.
We were, like, talking about party lines and scanners and stuff during the break.
Yeah. Yeah, the 900 numbers. I didn't know you used to be a moderator. Louis used to be a moderator.
For a 900 number?
And a 900 number in Boston when I was living there. Because it was the only job I could get that was from, like, I started at midnight and worked till 7 in the morning. And I had to listen to people's conversations. But it was always, like, 50 guys just in silence.
Why did you have to listen, by the way?
Because if they were rude, I was supposed to cut them off.
Oh,
and I also was supposed to spark conversation.
In case when there was a lull in the action, like, hey, guys.
Yeah.
Well, like, you're one of the guys, though, right?
I'm one of the guys I'm supposed to be. They knew I was a moderator. But anyway, there would always be these guys that would fight, start fights with each other. And they'd make plans to meet and fight somewhere. They'd go, like, I'm going to kick your ass. I'm going to kick your ass. Where are you, faggot? I'm in Quincy. How do I get to your house? All right, you know when you go, Route 1A? That's what we did that on the show. That's where that was from.
Route 1A.
Route 1A to the 7-Eleven, make a right. Oh, yeah. No, I know where that is. All right, I'm going to kick your ass, faggot. Every day that happened. And I'd leave. I was supposed to break those up, but I like listening to them. So sometimes I'd isolate two guys that hated each other on one line and let them fight.
And then a girl would come in and
everybody would just start, yo, can I get your number? Can I get your number? And then she'd leave.
She'd panic and leave, right?
Sometimes I would isolate the girl and masturbate on the phone with her. I really did. It was really foul.
As you're getting paid.
What a great kid.
It was a real creep.
That's wonderful.
Did she know you were a mod or no?
Yeah, that's how I, you know, they found that sexy. So I used to get girls to talk to me and I'd be in this little office.
Why wouldn't you
playing with myself? What?
Why wouldn't you meet them?
They're all fat. Who calls what attractive girl?
Yeah, exactly.
Calls anything.
What are you buying the commercials that go on?
Hi. Pretty. I saw
no
the commercial.
No pretty girl ever dials.
My
phone
name is Amber, and you
pretty
could call
just
me.
Pretty girls sit there, and people have sex with them when they want them to.
Yeah.
Yeah, the commercials for those are always the worst.
Some of the best times Ed and I had back in Boston was listening in on his scanner, his illegal scanner at the time.
I had a scanner, and I'd listen to cell phone calls and cordless phone calls from the apartment complex.
We would just get a ton of beer and just sit around on a Friday night just listening in on these conversations.
And then you'd hear like, brrr, you'd hear the ring and it would lock in on the signal.
And you never know what you're
here it comes, here it comes. And then sometimes it'd just be, hi, honey, I'm coming home from work or something. All right, see you in a little bit. Most of the calls are just, yeah, regular crap you hear every day.
Remember the guy crying because his wife caught him cheating?
Oh,
that was
one of
my
the
favorites.
Best ones
That's
too.
What guys always do. They cry.
The guy's crying. I know.
She goes,
what you did to our marriage after so long. She's crying, and the guy just went, I know.
Wait, he caught her cheating?
No, she caught him.
Oh, okay.
And so they were trying to work it out.
Okay.
With us listening in.
Oh, it's great. We're
you know,
laughing
he's
so hard.
Ball scores at that.
I know.
Wow,
I know.
This guy was a mush, man.
But we were talking about one call I got. We linked into it. We're just drinking beers, hanging out, having fun. And something someone said was funny, and we did the old
knee slapper. She was talking to some dude.
We kind of slammed our foot on the floor like, holy jeez, that was funny. And she goes, oh, those neighbors upstairs are constantly making noise. They're up late at night.
And it was you.
And we were like, oh, my God, she's right downstairs. So we tapped again. She's like, oh, making noise. Those upstairs always.
They never sleep.
I feel like, this is great. Let's really start screwing with her. So I had one of those vases with, like, pebbles in it and took some pebbles out and then went out onto my balcony. I was fourth floor. She was third. And started throwing pebbles at her sliding glass door. Like, I'd lean over the railing and throw it real hard. And she'd be, wait.
Oh, my God.
I'm hearing noises out on my patio.
It was like a horror movie.
It was a video game. It was an interactive
game. It really was.
And then we sent Jay from Framingham down to knock on her front door and run.
He was the drunkest.
Yeah.
And remember, he would panic. He would knock and start falling.
So I'm like, dude, just go downstairs. Yeah. It looks the same as this apartment door, only downstairs one flight.
Just
knock on it and run back upstairs.
Yeah.
Go, but be quiet.
And you would hear the stairs and the phone call, the guy panicking,
yeah,
running
everything
back
was
up
coming
the stairs.
Over. So she got so scared that the guy that she was on the phone with, she goes, could you please just come over and stay with me tonight? Because I'm afraid, you know,
yeah, we
stay
got this
on
guy
the phone.
Some action.
I'm afraid. It's like, geez, we got the guy got the guy laid. It was amazing.
That's awesome.
But it was interactive. We were just messing with her, and it was getting worse and worse.
Why did you have a vase with pebbles?
It was like one of those vases. Like, who knows? I've been divorced for friggin' 12 years.
That happens eventually.
That's why I had it.
Hey, Jimmy, not to top your Hammersteins thing, but New Year's Eve, I'm at the Ground Round in Parsippany, and Doug McClure is coming to see me.
Doug McClure.
Brock Peters.
Edward Norton requested to see you.
When you're a fan of somebody, don't you try to get tickets?
Shut up.
All right.
All right, let's go to Leah on Long Island. Leah.
I want big Hollywood friends.
Yeah. Leah.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi.
Ahoa!
not a straight night out. It's really Leah, not Leah. But that doesn't matter. All right. So I'm calling about my daughter. She's 15 today.
Lick that snatch.
She's 15?
Yeah, and, you know, she always, her older sister always steps in shit. She, like, everything good happens.
All right, let's
get with the curse.
Miss. You're a potty mouth is
enough.
What you are.
Enough. We're trying to get some of this on the radio. So, your daughter's 15 today. What do you want from us? And your other daughter gets lucky or something like that.
Yeah, she's very lucky, yeah. And what happened was a couple of weeks ago I had a garage sale and we were selling.
Boring.
No, wait. Gets better.
Okay.
So, And this guy buys a Nintendo. And as he buys it, she goes, I wanted that. I didn't want you to sell that. Now it's her birthday. And everything I went to buy, nothing was right. I had to return. She doesn't even know, like, what her presents are. And I realized that she wanted a Nintendo. But it's a Mario Brothers.
Oh, it's a Mario Brothers. So why don't you go buy her a Nintendo?
That's the good part.
They don't sell them anymore.
Therein lies the problem.
Okay, all right.
So what do you want from
now? Now I'm with you.
Okay, Dad, if you could put out on the radio, if anybody on Long Island has one that they're willing to sell me, I mean, not like to rip me off, but, you know.
How about this? I do have one.
Yeah, what are you looking to spend?
But I don't want money for it. Hey, listen, Mom.
Ooh.
I don't want money for my Nintendo. I actually have one that is basically just out of the box because right after I got it, I got an upgraded like a PlayStation. And I just didn't use it, so it's for all intents and purposes brand new. Now I know you're interested in that. How much would you be willing to pay for it?
What do you want to sell it for?
I don't want money. If you understand what I'm saying, here's the point I'm making. If you're willing to, let's just say. Enjoy a little throat yogurt. I will give you.
Okay.
I will give you this thing for your daughter's birthday.
Yeah, that's fair.
Oh, come on. It's her birthday. You got to do better than that.
That's why I'm not making her do it. I'm saying.
So funny. I don't know how that would go over.
All right. Well, then you don't want it. It's basically out of the box. I have no use for it.
You don't love her.
You don't sound like you.
Yeah, way to go.
I love her. I'm calling the show. I love her.
Way to look out for your daughter.
Yeah, go ahead.
You sold her Nintendo to get a garage sale, and now you're not even willing to do that.
Exactly.
To make up for it.
Hey, lady.
I got a husband that's begging for that.
Oh, my God.
Okay, then let him get the Nintendo.
Yeah.
Hey.
You should buy her a book.
Hey, stupid. Can I ask you something? Stupid. Do you have a computer? Do you own a computer?
I did the eBay thing. I couldn't find it.
Wait. No. Hold on. Do you have a computer?
Yeah.
All right. Just stick to the questions here. Do you know you can download any game that system could play onto your computer and play it? That you don't need that? That's why it's not sold anymore?
Yeah, but it's not the same thing.
You're right. Absolutely.
So yeah, it's not that awful television picture.
She likes it.
Just go to eBay. Why
is your daughter a retard?
Buy her a book or something. Those things,
a book.
It's not.
Guys are being mean. I listen to you every day.
We like you.
Then you know we're mean.
Just then answer the question. Is she a waterhead?
I know you're mean.
What has she got?
Waterhead.
My favorite is, what is it, ... me? That was very funny.
Right.
Oh, hysterical.
So what was your drink of choice during pregnancy?
... All right, listen.
The video game is going to make your daughter stupid. So buy her a book or something.
Like
don't
mom.
Buy it for her.
Right.
Doesn't matter that she wants it.
All right, listen, we got Tom on Long Island. Tom, can you help this girl out?
Yeah. I still have... She wants the original Nintendo, like the first one, not the Super Nintendo.
Yeah.
I still have it. Like, never used.
In the garden?
All right, never used. What?
She wants to play Duck Hunt. I say it like Duck Hunt,
right?
Because if you say it too quickly, it gets dumped out of.
Now there's something being thrown at your head.
Hey, by the way, I was in
Duck.
I still got this thing. If there's any way we could cut a deal here.
You ever been to Chinatown where they have duck vaginas? They sell them by the
No
barrel.
Way.
They sell them like by the barrel. Barrels of duck vaginas like with a scoop stuck in it.
Is it a delicacy?
Could we dominate a species more than that? We're selling their vaginas in big barrels with a scoop.
Wow.
I didn't want to try it because I'm afraid I'll, like, what if I love duck vaginas?
Then you're going to have to just go and get them all the time.
Because nothing could taste like a duck vagina. It's not like, it must be, like, really special.
No restaurant serve them.
No.
Bring yourself. Just cook this.
All right, listen, Tom, we got to go.
All right, man.
And Lee, I don't know what to tell you.
Lee, well, yeah.
Give me some oxycontin.
Lee?
Yeah.
You'll get nothing and like it.
Yeah, you lose. I'm sorry.
Yep. Sorry, your problems don't matter
That's
at
right.
all.
That's right. Bye-bye, bad mommy.
Jesus. Bye.
Not even close to mattering.
Not even.
We really got to get out of here. We're real late today. Louis C.K., Trump Marina, Saturday night. He did. You were great today. Thank you.
Thank
Come
you.
Back anytime, please.
Love to.
And Otto and George, you were great, too.
Thank you.
Tonight,
comics, 14th and 9th.
Yes, with Nina Hartley and myself in San Francisco. And then my New Year's Eve tickets go on sale Saturday for Atlantic City.
Charlotte next week at the Comedy Zone.
We're confusing everybody with 40 plugs. Who cares?
AutoGeorge.com.
And Jim Norton can be seen at... I like that Roland says my name, Norton.
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 All right, we had a lot of fun today, guys. If you're not joining us over at XM, have yourself a great day.
You know what I think... Hey, what's up? It's Lewis Twitchell Centanni.
Shut up!
Tourette's Day is coming to the Opie and Anthony Show, which is to say that we've discovered a new excuse to point and laugh at people who are different. To help us understand a little bit more about Tourette's, we've enlisted the help of hearing-impaired Chicago reporter Karen Meyer.
Tourette's syndrome is a neurological disorder that is characterized by involuntarily stick and repeated vocalization.
Exactly. So if you have Tourette's or if you know somebody with Tourette's, muster up some courage and an ounce of self-control and get in touch with the Opie and Anthony Show.
Contact Steve at foundrymusic.com. That's Steve at foundrymusic.com. And remember, be yourself, one tick at a time.
The Opie and Anthony XM Walkover begins now.
Oh, the music. Turn it down a little. Please. Why is that music so loud in our headphones? Outside Free FM giving out... they don't want us to mention it on XM?
No.
Oh.
Well, we are.
We're giving out all right.
Coupons.
The XM people are like... We're not getting our share.
What's up, Bato?
Cock-a-doodle-doo-suck-a-cock-a-nigga.
George is feisty today.
I'll say.
What I love about this gig, like when we're on Free FM, we have to be good boys as much as we can. Yeah. Louis C.K. decided not to be too good today. As far as the language, I mean, you were great on the radio. And then you get out here and you just want to go, fuck!
Hello, New York. Brush your teeth with my cock. Goggle with anthrax. Your mother's cunt then.
Just want to get the curses out. Get that energy out of you. All right. What are we doing? Anything?
I guess we're walking.
We'll take a walk over.
Let's take a stroll.
Let's take a stroll.
All right. We'll do that.
Hi, people.
Hi.
Hi. Kenny will be reading the dump report today. It was a good one.
Oh, it's got to be a nice long one. Nice long, juicy one.
I've gotten so used to, like, when people are talking now, I just start checking off things in my head, like, all right, he'll be reading that. Yeah.
Duck vaginas, hilarious.
Hello, sir.
I think that was only heard on XM.
How you doing, gentlemen?
Oh, yeah, they probably did dump it. Hi, boys.
Hey, guys.
A couple of fans.
Yeah, duck vaginas, did they,
I'm not sure.
Because it wasn't said in a sexual context.
No, it really wasn't.
Louis's mic's not on.
Oh, why would it be? E-Rock.
Eric, fix it.
Eric, you blithering incompetent.
Still not on.
Oh, why?
It's a culinary term. It's not a...
Yeah, it's what it is.
It is a duck vagina.
It was a duck vagina.
Stick a cock in it, it becomes profane.
How much of the chicken do you eat and then you're still hungry where you have to go
you're sitting there just going... just a vagina laying on your plate?
Yeah.
God,
like, I ate the entire fucking chicken. I'm just a little more hungry.
You ever eat chicken ass?
There you go.
No.
As a kid?
No.
You ever eat chicken ass as a
no.
kid?
No.
It's like literally as big as your thumb, the whole chicken ass?
$1.
What is going on?
he's pitching.
$2 duck vaginas. Check it out, New York.
Oh, look at this table. They don't know what's...
Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Business meeting.
We could have a problem here.
They look crabby.
Yeah. I'm going to need those TPS reports. Yeah.
Oh, those guys are miserable.
I'm going to need you guys to go ahead and come on in on Sunday. Yeah. Boy, are they miserable fucks.
We got a contest for you. We got a contest for her.
Oh.
What?
Look at her. Another one. 2 weeks.
God.
Doesn't she look like the 2 weeks woman?
Hold on. Anthony, we got someone that wants to imitate Dotto, I think.
All right.
Dotto's legs open, you whore.
Oh.
Eat me. What do you get when you shoot a cunt and a mother in the head? Peace and quiet.
Perfect. Peter Lorre.
Yeah, this is Peter Lorre. Like you.
All right, well, that was wonderful. Which way are we going today?
Anaga.
You're going to get hit. Come on. Hurry. We don't want you getting hit.
Oh, God.
I think your mic's off again.
Oh, no. Is that one off?
Yeah, the guest one is off. No, well, me and Lou will share one.
But how about we
fix it when I have my Hollywood friends in?
Oh, you and your Hollywood friends. Shut the fuck up.
Die.
I swear to God, you beep at me one more time.
Hey, guys, new homeless woman. New homeless woman.
Aw.
Wait, really?
Yeah. I wouldn't fuck with that. She looks like the chick from Thinner.
Oh, my God, yeah, she'll curse you. She'll put a curse on you.
I'd never take it off.
She looks like she's from that yogurt commercial where you eat the yogurt and live to 100.
You live
from Russia. Let's see what she's about.
Eat the yogurt and don't shower.
Hi, ma'am.
What are we looking for today?
What? What's the problem there, lady? She's going to put a voodoo curse on you. Gypsy curse.
You don't speak? You can't hear?
No, you're so good.
No hear? All right, well, we're not going to get much out of her.
She remembers the good old days.
All right, God bless. Do you have any money for you?
Adolf.
It's worthless.
What, you gonna toss her a couple of bucks?
Leave the 20s for myself, but here you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
God bless. Yeah,
boy.
She's kissing me, Aunt. Give me a kiss on the cheek.
Could I get away from Scatman Crothers and Bugs Bunny?
Kiss on the cheek.
Combined into one. It stinks over here. What the fuck? Just stinks.
God bless. I got a kiss from the homeless woman. What?
Ew.
You're a good boy. You're a sweetheart.
That's a curse, dude.
Why?
You're cursed now. She looked like a gypsy, like, give you a curse lady. Yeesh.
Yeesh.
And that corner just stunk today. Man. I like that. Yuck. Look at this. Oh, what's this guy with the cans and bottles? It's going to the...
Wow.
How much money he got in there? He's crossing the street. He doesn't want to steal him.
How much money is that?
That's about 50 $40? Cents right there, right?
$40.
That's not bad. Well, I can't hear. Here.
That's not...
20 a day. I make 20 a day.
20 a day?
I make $40 a day, but this is still like $15.
Where do you find a lot of your cans?
At the spots, you know, in front of the buildings.
In front of the buildings?
Outside the coffee shops. Oh, look at that.
Almost got hit by that
bus. That's what it is.
And what is this what you do full time?
I'm unemployed.
Oh.
I'm looking for a job, you know, so it's very hard.
So you do that
find
and
work, you know, because I'm like semi-retired, you know, very close to retirement.
What did you used to do?
Financial analyst.
Wow.
Well, you know, that's today.
You were a financial analyst?
Yes. Today.
If you're doing this, what the fuck are your old clients doing?
But today is very difficult because they have the computer network.
People right.
People can't get information from the computer.
They don't need you anymore.
They don't need the
financial
analyst. Himself.
You're right.
Because the information is in the computer.
But don't they need somebody on the other end of the computer?
No, they need the big guys.
So why don't you do that?
Now you tell your clients, like, Diet Pepsi cans are up.
Yeah.
Fanta. Mountain Dew cans
are
doing moving well.
Radio?
What do you think this is?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's a little bit of radio.
Oh, okay. Hey,
you got any Fresca?
That's what I call talent. Very good.
That's what I call talent,
no,
he says.
No, really. I used to write a little bit of poetry in college, you know.
Oh, do you remember any?
Huh?
Do you remember any?
Any of your poems?
Any poetry? Maybe you can recite some.
I have that talent.
Can you recite a little for us?
I don't remember any. It's been a long time.
You don't remember poetry?
No, it's been a long time. Oh, who's behind me? How are you?
Oh, wow.
You look familiar.
You know, if you crush the cans, you could put more in the bag.
Oh, wow. That's a pretty smart thing, Kenny.
Financial advice for the can picker.
Is that a... Yeah. I used to be a wolf man.
Well, no one can hear you, sir.
Yeah, there you go.
If you recycle aluminum, you crush the cans, and put them in, you know, take them to the recycling center. Yeah. But I sell it 5 cents each. Yeah. You know, which is the deposit. You know, 1,000 cans is $50. You know.
Oh, you know your math. You know your math.
Okay.
I want to hear some.
Okay,
poetry.
He's had enough.
I gotta keep.
Yeah, I want to hear some poetry.
Yes, we want to hear some poetry, some homeless poetry.
I don't remember any. It's been a long time, my friend.
How about roses are red, violets are blue? My balls smell like Katrina just blew over them.
Can I see how heavy the cans are?
Yeah, because he lugs them around.
You can't judge a man until you hold.
This isn't going to be good. Oh, he's now holding the cans.
Wow, these are really. How much is this?
$240 and $60.
Just
$300.
Just
$300.
Just put them in the middle. Just leave them in the middle of 57th.
Wow.
Hope he's walking around now with the guy's cans. That's $15.
Damn it, the NYPD just drove by. I can't do it.
Look, he's looking at you.
He's looking at it. Well, hey, there goes that bit. I'm not that brave. Enjoy your can, sir.
What does he make, $40 a day?
He's talking to you. I don't know.
$40 a day.
XM Radio, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I remember.
You subscribe to that?
Okay.
It's only 8,000 cans a month.
Hey, we got some Burger King coupons for you. All right, God bless. You have no idea how lucky you are today, sir.
Hey, man, let me double your daily take there. That's double your income.
Hey, oh, that's
Louis
nice.
CK
throwing a few 20s.
Hey, the guy's nice.
I make
and
a lot
shaving.
More than him.
Next time. I remember the poetry.
Yeah, remember
next
poetry
time.
Next time.
We're here every morning, so you come by with poetry. You don't expect a handout every morning, but if you do some poetry, it could be worth a few bucks, I'm thinking.
Okay, once in a while.
Yeah.
What? All right, there you go, my friend. What's your name?
Yeah, what's your name?
Bottle guy. What's your...
Charles Frank. Frank Gonzalez.
Okay, very good.
Frank.
There goes Frank.
Yes. He's been arrested so many times, he knows to say his last name first.
Yeah.
Frank.
Can I tell you what I was going to do?
We'll just call him Frankie Cans.
I was going to dump all the cans in the middle of 57th Street. I was just about to start doing it.
Oh, that would have been.
And an NYPD car, like, makes the left on a 57th.
Yeah, and he was looking at the...
And he was looking right at me because I was looking a little suspicious.
My life is better than that guy.
Yeah? You think?
A lot better.
It is. It does put things in perspective.
I don't have to carry stuff like that around.
Yeah, carry around a ton of cans.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm not him in every way.
Right. How is this guy?
Smelly ear.
Who's this guy walking with us? It's a shine. They call it the shine.
Oh. He's a comedian.
He just told me what you was going to do.
I've known him for many, many years.
Hey, have you?
I've seen him in the
cop. Should tell Mr. Miller his car's here. Mr. Miller? Mr. Miller?
Mr. Miller?
Go ahead.
Mr. Miller?
Mr. Miller? Get in the car, Mr. Miller.
Trying to throw a flea into Mr. Miller's car.
Miller.
All right, why don't we keep rolling?
Mr. Miller.
You suck, flea.
Flea, you ruined the bit.
Yeah, flea.
You could have just hopped in.
Yeah. What's up, Big A? All the regulars out here today.
Is this your car? Is that Big A's car? Is that your car?
Actually, just today. We drive a Crown Victoria just today. I know it's a piece of shit, but...
Whose car is it?
It's company's car.
This is a
Look
company
at the
car?
Trunk.
This is a company
wow.
car?
What, did this thing back into you?
Wow, no, those are kick marks on the inside.
Yeah, I don't have it all the time.
This is awful. We'll have the picture up on opiananthony.com.
Jesus. Andrew, this is horrid.
You drive people around as a cab driver in this thing?
Yes, actually, I dropped off in the area. That's why I popped over here today.
Wow. All right. They're going to think this thing is abandoned or something.
That is the worst. Who gets in this and actually wouldn't just hop in a cab? Like, why would you call this and get this fucking car? If this car pulled up to get me one day, I would...
It's got sweet rims.
I'd punch
look at
you.
Those rims. Nice. I'm going to let the air out. Jesus.
Oh, shit. Hope he's letting the air out of the tire.
Wow. The car has been dying to do that since Big A sat in it.
Wow, that is awful. Wow, and then you come in this car to pick me up?
We just gave the money to the wrong guy, I think. We really need to give Big A the money. You coming upstairs today, Big A?
I can't. I have to get back up to the Bronx.
What do you got to... Oh, the Bronx. Okay.
Yeah.
So usually, what, do you pull up in front of banks, they jump in, and you speed off?
Of course, why not?
Great. How many would you say black people to white people ratio per day for you?
More white people. I pick up in Riverdale, some more white people.
Really?
Yeah.
More white people?
Yeah.
I would think up there in the Bronx.
Yep. Bronx, more white people.
Good. See me? Stereotype? What do I know?
Well, there you go.
All right. That's, what's this on the mirror?
I don't know. Bulletproof stuff, I think.
Jesus.
Bye, Andrew.
How are you, Phil?
All right.
Some kind of lock thing on the grill. What a mess.
Sir?
Cars like him. A disaster.
I think that's about it today.
Yeah.
Unless you want to have a tomato fight.
Ooh. Throw one of those cherry tomatoes.
Who's your car? No, this is
whose truck?
Yours? Oh. Who's going to mess with your tomatoes?
Oh, what's going on here? Tomatoes, hey, hold on.
Holy sh... Oh, my God. Up.
Hi, miss. Hi, miss.
Wow. What do you think, sir?
Very nice. Very nice, dude. Yeah.
Your skirt right. blew up, ma'am.
Everybody saw it. Your skirt blew up.
I couldn't help it.
All right. Let's go upstairs.
Yep, let's take it up for part two. Part dual. Part dux of the show.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. OBN Anthony, XM 202.
You people only knew what goes on here while this music is playing for an hour. Must be important stuff, right? No, it's not. Oh. Do we have to fix that? Problem?
I'm not really sure.
Oh, it's not the incorrect.
Yeah, look.
You shit.
I can't get anything on the air.
The machine's not working, fam. Fix it immediately.
Problem?
No, it says Ron and Fez, so it might be hooked up for
Ron
them.
Ron and Fez.
That doesn't matter?
It shouldn't.
Yeah, my machine doesn't work today.
The hot chick that Kenny, when she's walking across the street, Kenny goes, your skirt blew open?
Yeah.
She's on her elevator. And she was really nice, and she goes, someday your tooth is going to hurt. She's a dentist in the building with those big, beautiful breasts. And I made an appointment on the elevator. See, I want to get a teeth whitening, so I wanted to do that.
She's anyway. An actual dentist?
Oh, yeah. And I'm such a chauvinist asshole. She's like, I'm a dentist. I'm like, really? And everybody on the elevator laughed. It's like, yeah, we come in all sizes and shapes.
All kinds of dentists.
Oh, she was sexy, man. I would love her to work on my teeth.
And she's got to have a crazy business.
Yeah. She certainly will. I'll go and...
Getting cleanings twice a week?
Awesome.
Right, and then so does the laundromat right downstairs because I come in my pants.
DJ Anna Lightbulb from posthors.net. Ope, what happened to foaming pussy? I thought that had potential.
Oh, I was undermined.
Huh?
I closed down the Opie and Anthony room.
Yeah.
As a joke because... baby girl was just sitting there with her shirt off, and everybody was, like, drooling. So I, as a joke, I shut the room down until we got over here. They all just went to another room. So now our room is empty, and the fan room is full.
See, it backfired.
Boring. It backfired.
I was just, now that thing works. But now I need my instant feedback back. Who's this new guy? Who's the new guy that's messing me up here today? All right, thank you.
One new guy.
Ed, foaming pussy. Yeah, we thought that had potential. We got to get that going again. We got to go back to the lab with that and make that happen.
Back to the lab.
So far, we've had one girl do foaming pussy. See how different things are over here, Louis?
Foaming pussy, yeah. Foaming pussy is great.
I'm looking at the dumps from the other show.
Yeah.
It says that I said, may I blow your dad? I don't remember saying that. Did I say, may I blow your dad? I don't remember what the fuck...
It was a Freudian slip.
What the context was.
Well, well, there's...
Was that just something I said to you? Just like, you got a light for a cigarette? Can I blow your dad?
No, what's weird is they also read your mind over there. And they added to the dump sheet, so...
Well, she's a cunt, I remember that.
It's a new technology they're trying out over there. Hey, let's do the dump report with Club Soda Kenny.
Live from the Opie and Anthony Show studios, the Daily Dump Report.
we start off 6:09 a.m. a caller. You guys make me piss my pants every morning.
Oh, I can't say piss your pants.
That sucks.
That's nuts.
We needed a compliment, too.
And then he backed it up again, 6:09, and I piss my pants.
That seems so light. Yeah. I mean, if he said, like, you make me shit in my mother's vagina every morning.
Right.
Then I could understand.
Yeah.
I laugh so hard, I shit in my mother's cunt. That's funny. That's funny material.
Yeah, you know you're laughing
hard. Mom, come over here.
You know you're laughing hard.
Yeah.
7:51 a.m., Louis C.K. makes his debut. Piece of shit like you.
I don't remember that either.
Talking about Jimmy Norton.
That's right. That's right.
Backs it up, 7:53 a.m., Louis C.K. She's got shitty timing.
And do we have no Saget dumps? I thought he got dumped a couple of times, no?
Oh my God.
He was good.
No,
are you kidding?
He did all right today. He didn't get... I'm sure he should have been dumped for something.
He's network.
Oh my God.
Yeah, he's network Bob now. He's network Bob.
And stuff like that.
Nah, he's network Bob, though. Yeah. He knows how to do it.
Yeah.
Sure, he did tap dance around the regulations.
Yeah, you know.
That Bob's a good boy.
7:56 a.m., a caller chimed in. Asshole, and fucking.
not cool.
7:58, Louis C.K. again. Piss all over the place.
As if pissing in pants isn't bad enough. Yeah. Now you're just pissing all over the place.
All willy-nilly.
I don't remember piss all
And here, 7:58, apparently Louis' favorite line, may I blow your dad?
No memory of it. No memory of it this very morning, and I don't know why I said it.
You just said it and you don't remember.
No,
just told
may I
you
blow
that.
Your dad?
I don't know what.
8:23.
May I?
I know, it's so proper. Right.
Well, it wasn't dumped for grammar.
That's normally something you say to a girl when you're picking up on a first date.
No one's going to punch you if you put it in those terms.
No.
May I blow your dad?
Yeah.
Well, no, you may not.
No, right, but...
defensive. Put all this cock in my mouth. What's wrong with you?
Just hold it in there.
8:23, we can't leave Otto and George out.
No.
Oh, my aching cunt.
That was right on the line, though. They must have hesitated. Just to be safe.
Otto's only been on our show 100 times. He's still learning. He's going to be there soon.
It's always the gray area.
Yeah. It's not Otto. It's George that's got the problem.
That's right.
Otto's fine.
Yeah. And then Louis C.K., 8:26.
As Paul McCartney, I said this.
She's a cunt.
That was as Paul McCartney.
I believe it was more of a cunt.
A cunt. She's a cunt.
A cunt.
8:52 a.m., Louis C.K., isolate the girl and masturbate on the phone with her.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
8:56, Otto and George again, lick that snatch.
Nice.
Wow, it sounded just like him.
Almost.
Yeah. You didn't read the entire description.
Do you ever do phone sex, Jimmy? Are you into that?
I used to be until the computer, but many times.
Yeah.
Many times.
I find that, I sometimes they stray into an area that you're not into.
Oh, no.
And you have to politely ask, because they assume, like, you're on with it. She's like, yeah, I'm going to lick your cock. And I'm like, yeah. And then she goes, I'm going to stick my finger in your ass. And I go, oh, no, not really. But she thinks, she's like, yeah, no, you little fag, I'm going to stick. And then I have to go, okay, I'm the paying customer, and I don't want you to do that.
No, I mean it.
No, I mean, no, I'm not. And she's like, oh, I'm sorry. And then we go back to it.
The last dump of the day from that stupid woman caller who wanted a Nintendo.
Yeah.
Steps in shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
I got, you know, remember Drake Sather?
I know the name.
Comedian shot himself in the head. And he was a friend of mine. I was having phone sex in a hotel and on my cell phone. And then I got a call on the other line. It was my manager telling me that he shot himself.
Who was
that? And I'm fully hard and close to coming. And my manager says, did Drake just shot himself? And I'm like, oh. Like, I can't properly grieve until I get rid of this boner.
Yeah.
So I had to go, like, I'll call you right back, and I had to finish my fucking phone sex.
Wow.
Because otherwise I'm, like, talking about poor dead Drake with a hard-on.
Yeah, with a hard-on.
So I gotta get rid of it.
And
I'm
not gonna... balls.
Yeah. I don't want to jerk off to him.
Wow, that's rough.
I did remember hearing that a couple years ago.
Like a year ago now.
Did it... Did it flash in your mind as you were finishing up?
Of course. Oh. It was not flash, it was prominently.
Prominent. Yes. Oh, God damn.
You can hear it reverberating.
How the fuck do you finish?
Well, I had to.
I got something in common. You both got shot.
Oh, that's right.
All right, we got to take a break. They got to fix the equipment.
What's the matter?
I just got to communicate from Dan. I don't know. They're going to, like, do some adjustments.
And our guest mics didn't work, so apologies to Otto and to Louie. They had to share a mic, and it did not work.
And I have to apologize to all the pals. Talkers.
Why?
Because I shut the room down before we left. And I have to apologize for that, or else they won't let Baby Girl back into our room.
All right, please come back. We apologize for him.
See, it's so easy to get an apology out of us.
You tried to put your foot down, and it landed in shit.
When we get back, the story of the day that we couldn't even attempt to touch over at the other place. So we'll do it right after the break.
Next time on a very special Everybody Loves Raymond. Ray's brother needs a helping hand.
Ray, I got a problem, man. You gotta help me.
Oh.
I picked up a tranny last night at Hunts Point, and there was an accident.
No.
We were trying this erotic asphyxiation thing, and she was supposed to pitch me before it ran out of air.
What are you doing?
But Ray's father isn't buying it.
What a load of bull. Come on.
All right, you got me. I picked him up on 10th Avenue.
The family hijinks don't stop there.
Ray, you gotta help me get rid of the body.
I don't wanna do it.
No, come on, it'll be fun. We'll chop it up and bury it out in Jersey.
I live on Long Island.
All on the next Everybody Loves Raymond. Tonight at 8.
We're back. Louis C.K. in studio. Otto and George in studio. Lots to do today. This is the story we couldn't do over at Free FM.
Yeah, a little bit of a problem.
Which is fine.
Doing it over there. So we come over here.
We're over here now.
That's what we do now.
Yeah. This is probably the story of the day. Although I got another story in front of me here. Naked drunk driver kills man on Staten Island.
Naked drunk driver.
Woman.
A woman was naked?
Yeah, you want to start with this?
Yeah, let's start with that and segue into the love story at the bowling alley.
Right. Because this is pretty interesting, too. She was naked, but she was smart enough to be wearing her seatbelt.
Mm. All right.
That's all she was wearing.
She could have hurt herself.
On Staten Island now, and a man is killed while trying to cross the street overnight, and police say that the woman who hit him was driving naked and drunk. Eyewitnesses reported Lisa Calagrassi is live now in West Brighton with details for us.
All right, hottest drunk driving story ever.
She's giving naked drunk chicks a bad name. It's not fair.
Yeah, really. Not all of them are naked and drunk.
And killing people.
Yeah.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with being a naked drunk woman.
What if she was driving fine and somebody. This idiot just ran in front of her car?
Yeah.
You know, she might have been good at driving drunk and naked.
She had to flee for what reason? That's what you got to think.
Yeah. She was leaving, like, or she just all drunk. I'm fucking leaving. One of those.
Got in
a fight with her fucking boyfriend or husband, and they're laying in bed, they're naked, some fucking fight starts over crumb up her ass or something, and then she just, I go, fuck it, I'm fucking leaving, and just walks out the door of the car.
Wouldn't you take your clothes in a pile, maybe?
No, and the passenger seat at the...
Yep.
That drunk.
Or somebody fucked her that well that she ran out of the room screaming into a car and ran a dude over.
She had to tell people how great someone fucked her. I got to go to a mall and tell everyone how great he fucked her.
Oh, she hits the gas and the jizz just rolls back with those french fries collect behind the seat.
Yuck.
Right with details for us, Lisa.
Good morning, Lori. And the man was actually crossing the street to meet his brothers at a bar when he was hit and killed by a speeding car. Now, police say a naked, drunk woman was behind the wheel. That's the car she was driving. It wound up being flipped over. She also hit that car, a red car, with a man and a woman inside. Fortunately, they were treated and released with minor injuries. The driver,
they were clothed.
24-year-old Talia Taylor, is now being charged with DWI and vehicular manslaughter. The victim has been identified as 41-year-old Big Larry Simon.
Big Larry.
Big,
so long, Big Larry.
Big dead Larry Simon.
Oh, damn, poor Big Larry.
What a way to go.
What a way to go, right? Because you know at the funeral it's going to be all somber and shit, but everyone's going to go, dude, you got hit by a drunk naked bitch.
Couldn't
what are the fucking odds?
What are the odds?
Weird.
It takes away from your life, though, because they're not going to be talking about you at the funeral.
No.
No, it's, it ruins your funeral.
Right.
It's not, you know, the fucking eulogy.
Yeah. Big Larry was a man you could always go to. Holy shit, fucking naked drunk run. Whenever you had a problem, Big Larry was there. Helping out and fucking naked broad ran him over. She was drunk.
It's just a horrible night. I mean, I go to the social club and I just see a guy laying killed in the street. And then I go to the bar and I'm there with his brother.
Changes the whole story. William Wallace dead in Staten Island.
The fuck? He was killed in the street. Was he?
Then I go in the bar, and I'm there with his brothers, and they didn't even know that it was their brother laying in the street.
Taylor is being treated here at St. Vincent's Hospital for only minor injuries. She may not have been wearing any clothes, but she was wearing a seatbelt. Police say she was incoherent when she was brought to the hospital.
His brothers were waiting for him in the bar. Where the fuck is he? Fucking faggot. Where the fuck did he go? Oh, he's dead.
I want to tell him this story about some drunk naked chick they just arrested.
Where the fuck is he?
Jesus, the twists and turns fucking life takes, man.
No kidding. Do we want to go here today?
Oh, no. Lady Di?
We'll make it fast. Lady Di.
Hey, how you doing?
How are ya?
Hey, drunk.
Okay, how's everything?
Lady Di, Marion was in the other day. Let's do a quick recap. Lady Di used to be on our show. She was part of the retarded Laverne and Shirley, we call them. Childhood friends, Lady Di.
I'm sure.
And Marion, shut the fuck up, shut the fuck up, shut the fuck up. So, Marion is married and doing fine, has been for years. Lady Di lost her job. Became a drunk, became homeless, lost her young teenage son, where he now has to stay with her father because she's an incompetent mother. Then ended up homeless.
Shut up.
You did.
Okay, go ahead. But anyway, go ahead.
Ended up sleeping and giving blowjobs at the train station in Jersey. While you were homeless, to other homeless guys. Welcome to the show.
Wait a minute. She's homeless, blowing homeless.
Yeah.
We're not just
blowjobs are supposed to get you up the ladder. You don't blow other homeless people.
She's blowing away down.
No.
Well, blow me down.
That's what it meant. I always wonder what Popeye meant by that.
Wrong about that. Oh my goodness.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah,
right.
Look at the way Romer's
homeless
get around
splurge.
Like that. You know.
Disgusting.
Come on.
So what's the update? Yeah, now Marion came in and said, you're not homeless anymore.
Right, I'm not homeless anymore.
Where do you live?
Do you still blow homeless guys?
I live in Elizabeth.
Yeah.
She's
old time
now.
Yeah.
She gets nostalgic.
Can I suck your cock for old time's sake?
No. Sorry, Sal, can't do it.
I miss the smell of rotted flesh and metallic tinge.
I'm
imagining, of course.
Hi, George.
Oh, stop saying hi to people.
All right, just get on with it.
Listen, we want to know what happened.
You're on the clock. You don't have much time today.
Okay, I don't have much time today. I just called you up just about 2 minutes ago.
Hey, idiot. Listen
now,
to us.
Now you have less time.
What happened? You live somewhere now. Where do you live? Is it a homeless shelter, or do you have
a
house that you're paying rent for?
It's not a homeless shelter, and yes, I do have to pay the rent.
Is it a halfway house?
No, it's not.
Are you drinking?
Are you still drinking?
No.
Yeah, that's a yes. Right, that's a yes.
That's a yes.
That's a yes. On occasion.
Well, okay, on occasion.
All right, good. How's your son?
And now that
my
you have a home.
Doing good. I just talked to him last night.
Well, no, that now that you're home, your son probably lives with you now, right?
Well, no, he still lives over my dad's house.
Why is that?
That's a better environment for him.
As per who?
As per my dad has a house and I do not.
As per maybe social services.
No. I don't want.
You're a failure as a mother. You're a failure as a wife.
I am not. Anthony,
why don't you let everybody know how your husband
is a homeless blower, though.
As
one of the best.
Okay, listen.
Why don't you let everybody know what your husband did, so we wouldn't have to live with you anymore or go through divorce proceedings or anything. Let everyone know what your husband did.
All right,
and go.
Let's hear this again.
What did my husband do?
And go. How did your husband get out of being married to you? And go.
My husband got out of being married to me because I divorced him.
No. But just the memory of you that wouldn't leave.
Just being married to you drove him to
What finally happened?
No,
what finally happened? Floor is yours.
First of all,
your husband kissed a blank.
Richard Dawson.
I said I killed himself.
I'm going to say a choo-choo train. Yeah, your husband
decided.
I saw your commercial on television, and you looked really nice.
Yes, sir. What happened? That's nice of you. What happened to your husband?
It doesn't matter.
Just tell Louis because he doesn't know what's going on. We're trying to paint you as a complete person, and you're running around in circles. Tell Louis because he cares.
He cares.
Please tell me.
Okay. All right. Do I have to get into this again?
Yes, briefly, because he doesn't know.
Quickly.
Okay. Does he listen to the show on a daily basis, you know, from what's next?
Get to the point.
Get to the point. What happened to your husband? Louis C.K. wants to know.
What happened?
No, I wasn't married to this.
Okay, we don't care. Just say
He's
what happened.
He's got his finger on the button. You're going
to be gone
in seconds.
Okay. Come on now. What happened?
This is what happened. He committed suicide.
There you go.
How?
Were you going to play that?
How?
Louis C.K. needs to know.
Don't start me on this.
Just get it. Just tell us how.
How? Yeah.
How? Okay.
How do you do it?
No, not the word how.
Yeah.
Jesus.
How?
How do you do it?
Yeah, this is the first time Louis has been on our show. He needs to know.
I'm not an Indian, you know. No. Anyway, what happened
buffalo.
Was...
buffalo.
Yes.
Thank you.
How did he do it?
Okay, no. This is... No. He...
Just
he,
say it.
This was years ago. This was back in...
We know!
Oh, my God. Do you want to punch her in the face?
This might be freeing.
Do you just want to punch her?
Just tell me what. How did he do it? What was the method?
You want me to get to the point?
Yes.
What was the method?
He just decided to end his life and put himself in front of a train. There's nothing funny about that.
Of course not.
Keep on bringing that up.
Was that a Will and Grace laugh? Or was it...
Is that really necessary to keep
Maybe,
on
you know what?
If you're going to come on the radio on a show like this, I think you must expect
yeah.
it.
Well, a bit. Lady Di, listen to me. If it helps you out any, you can just imagine that instead of killing himself, he actually was trying to get back with you, and he thought he was running to hug you.
No, fucking train.
Wait a minute. Shut up. You're probably saying it too harshly. He jumped in front of a train.
She said he put himself.
He put himself
in front of a train.
Like in theory, he was trying to empathize with the train. He put himself
in the place of the train.
No, Diane, what you should have said is this.
Why do you keep on asking me?
Here's
that?
How you say it to make
it's
it
funny
gentle.
Every time.
It's like a joke that just never gets old.
That's right.
Die, here's how you say it. From now on, die. Here's how you say it. Don't say jump in front of a train. That's too cruel. Yes. When they say what happened to your ex-husband, say he decided to smooch a choo-choo.
Yeah, that sounds nice.
See? He's not my ex-husband, first of all.
What is he?
I was never married to him.
No.
Oh.
He ate a caboose.
But why do you have to keep on bringing that up?
Because it's really interesting.
I don't know why.
You broke up with him? You wrote him out on a rail, did you?
Have
your tickets ready.
Otto, please.
Did he leave a note?
No.
Yeah, any note? Oh, good question.
Yes, my pancreas will be stuck under the dining car of the number 207. From Rochester to Hartford.
Please leave my three undamaged toes to science. Shut up, we're laughing at you.
And you got to... You have to bring that up. Come on.
What did he write in the note? Like, after goodbye,
I
bitch.
Don't know.
To collect my legs, you must change at Jamaica. Change at Jamaica.
What? You know, let me tell you something. She's not going to be happy with you guys.
What?
She's not going to be happy with you guys if she's listening to the show, because I don't have the XM yet.
Oh.
You're the best.
Cares about her.
Come on. That's your godson.
Did he leave a note? Did your guy that wasn't your husband?
I don't know because I wasn't with him.
Well, someone might have told you because it was obviously your fault that it happened. So did he say that in the note?
I'd like to tell my loved ones. No.
Should have given him some more time. I looked at his watch. Our train schedule.
I'm telling you the truth. And guys, you got to stop bringing that up. Come on.
All right, you're right.
Yeah, you're right.
You're right.
No.
You're absolutely right.
All right, let's get back Amtrak.
You're right.
Yeah.
No.
I actually said this is what a hack I am. Hold on, shut up, Fatso. I said let's get back Amtrak like a funny wordplay when on track would have worked as well.
It was perfect. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't enter that because I'm not. Let's not.
Let's not get into.
He just wanted to test the Doppler effect with his lungs outside of his body.
Everybody's doing okay over here, and yeah, everyone's the train. Yeah, you gotta play. play that again.
Was this your wedding song?
No, it was not. I was never mapped.
She says, right, no, it was right. Not. Actually, no. I think it was the Titanic theme. It wasn't the drain whistle.
You sure it wasn't clang, clang, clang with the trolley?
Guys, we were not married to each other.
Right, but
I married later on to someone else.
Yeah, but the kid, you know. Did he ever read as a child the book The Little Engine That Could Kill Me?
If I stood in front of it like an adult.
No. You know, he's 16 years old now, you know.
Cool.
What?
My son, he's 16 years old right now.
Yeah, and now he can actually know that his mother's a waste.
And he's 6'4", and I see him, you know, I go over there and everything like that.
Boy's gonna come and beat us up now. Fucking son's gonna come and kick the shit out of us.
I'm not saying that. I mean, you know,
this was fun 8 years ago when he was.
I know, when it was a poor little kid.
Right.
You know, you can't change the past.
How old was your ex-husband when he died from metal hitting his body?
Yeah, how old was he?
Oh God.
On purpose.
I'm 44. Why do you keep on asking me these questions?
How old was he? It is a good question.
This was back 2001, so you figure it out.
How old?
He would have been 43.
He was 2000. Oh,
40.
Going
to say.
It was 2001.
Well, it's just 5 years.
So
what was the date?
Was about maybe two. He was about 39 years old.
What was the date that he died on purpose?
Well, why do you have to keep on bringing that up?
What was the date?
I agree. What was the date?
October, I think it was maybe October 26th.
I'm trying to see if it was pre, so it was after September 11th.
Yeah.
We're all still reeling from September 11th.
Maybe that was
something
it.
Like
so
that.
It was either that or right before Halloween, and he wanted to go his 30 different things, and he couldn't decide.
Jim, you know, you guys, come on. I'm only telling you I'm doing better, and you keep on bringing that up. What's wrong with you guys?
Who's the dope that does that to himself, like, within 6 months of September 11th? You know you're getting no press.
Yeah, no.
Exactly.
I wanted to call you up to let you know I'm doing good, and you got to go bring that up again.
Yeah, no, tell us what's going on with you. Are you okay? Tell us what's going on with you.
What was that?
Tell us what's going on with you. We'd like to know how you're doing.
So things
what's
are
going on with me
things
right
are
now?
Looking up. Like your husband saw, you see a light at the end of the tunnel.
Oh, God. I kind of expected that from that.
Yeah.
You know, no,
did
everything, everything is going good right now.
Smart.
I'm not working today because there's no work for me today.
Well,
I figured I'd give you I was going to call you up on a...
What are you doing now? Who cares? What are you doing now for work?
Giving hand jobs to pigeons.
No, I still do warehouse work.
No work today because the hobos are collecting cans.
Warehouse. That's funny.
Yeah,
she said the same thing when she was homeless. Warehouse.
Right.
Warehouse.
I am not homeless.
Don't laugh.
Oh my God! I should have came up to the studio with Marion some one day.
Oh yeah,
and
what would that have
came
done?
Up there.
What would that?
You know,
have
no,
done?
No, no, no. But no. She went over to the Columbus Day Parade, and it was our day off and everything like that. So I just, you know, I just stayed home, and that was it. And that
just
was it.
Babbles.
I babble and I babble.
You
that's right.
Babble.
So that's it. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I should have came up there and everything, but I got up a little too late.
No. Oops. She ought to pay that phone bill.
Mm. Yeah.
Wow. Why is it so funny?
I guess for me, it's because it's not me.
Oh, yeah.
I don't care.
That's good. That's always the rule number one. It's not me, and so, I didn't know him.
Yeah, so I just don't. What befalls others doesn't actually bother me at all.
Yeah.
Because it's not me.
God damn, you fit in well here. It's so true. The further away they are, the
no,
less
like
I care.
I was checking into an airport security once, and there's a guy trying to push past people because he's late. Like, he's like, I'm going to miss my flight. And I'm like, no, you can't go in front of me.
Yeah, don't care.
And he's like, what time's your flight? And I'm like, in like 3 hours. I'm very early. But we don't line up by what time your fucking flight is. We line up by what time you started standing here.
Right.
And he's like, I'm going to miss my flight because you won't. And I'm like, you're not me, so I don't care.
Because
you don't live in my body, so I won't be late.
Yeah, because it's the last guy in the chain of events that got this guy to the airport this late.
Yeah.
You?
Yeah, no. And even if it was, I still won't give a shit.
Yeah, who cares?
I don't care.
I got 3 hours. But if I was late to the airport,
yeah.
I'd be like, I'm getting in front of you.
Yeah. I'm not going to ask you.
Because it's me.
Yeah.
I'm going to figure this out. Yeah. All right, story of the day. Sorry for that interruption there. This is great. Listen in.
We're going to begin with that attack on Long Island, and it is, frankly, beyond shocking. A developmentally disabled man, a bowling alley worker, viciously attacked by two teenagers, sexually abused with a plumber's snake. The two teenagers are now charged. Who would do this? And why? It happened at a bowling alley in Shirley.
And why not?
That's why Rivers News reporter Jim Dolan is for us tonight. Jim?
The two-part and Bill, question. First, a bit of a warning. There just is no way to tell this.
Oh, that's great. He's got to warn him.
He's dope.
Bit of a warning. By the way, I'm fucking speechless here.
Wouldn't it be funny? He said, bit of a warning. There's no way to tell this without laughter.
Make him believe they're getting something done.
You can't. Yeah.
Here you go.
Oh, bit of a great warning.
Horrible, depraved story without being more graphic than any of us would like to be. Keep in mind that the victim in this case is a 21-year-old developmentally disabled man described here at the bowling alley by people as friendly and innocent. He is a maintenance worker who people here say would never hurt anyone. But on Sunday night, according to police, he was followed into the men's room by two men, one of whom held him down and the other one sexually assaulted him with a plumber's tool.
I don't want any story about me, no part of any story about me to be described by people at the bowling alley as.
There is a great line here in the Post.
Plumber snake.
Where it says, they're talking about the fallen maintenance employee of AMF Shirley Lanes into the bathroom. He was a Shirley Lane employee.
Shirley Lanes.
Shirley, your asshole can't be sore. And it says, as one teen held the victim down, the other forced the plumbing snake inside him and spun it several times.
Wow.
The man suffered severe pain, bleeding, and internal injuries.
Wow. See those things?
And a little bit, he's a little ashamed, too, probably. A little, he's a little embarrassed. He's a little embarrassed.
I don't care how developmentally challenged you are. That part of you is not.
I may be retarded, but this is kind of a drag.
Wow. I really don't think this is right.
No. You ever think what these guys do right after a crazy act like that, before the cops discover what
like,
happened?
Like, and then throw the snake down.
And then what?
And go,
what's the...
what do we...
Shit. Did we just do that?
Yeah, did we just do that?
Yeah.
Did I just hold him down while you shoved that plumber snake up his ass?
Dude, why do we do this?
Did we?
Dude.
But how did they come to it? Like, did one guy...
Well, that's what I wanted, because you look at the picture, that, like, these kids... I get that you're, you know, you're a teenager, you're bored.
Yeah.
But how did he, you know, hey, my dad's got a plumber snake. But, you know that retarded guy at the bowling alley?
Why don't we get him in the bathroom, you hold him, and I'll snake it up his ass, and then, you know, we'll do 10 frames.
Like, what the fuck? Got any quarters? I want to play Miss Pac-Man.
Hey, Jim in Jersey. Jim!
Yo, I got a pat from Moon Hockey Line.
Okay.
I guess they gave him the old 7-10 split.
Yeah, that is a pat from Moon Hockey Line. Devoid of humor.
All right, there you go. There's more to the story here.
Of course there is.
Oh, the reporter goes to the address of one of the suspects.
Oh, that's good.
At the address police sources give for one of those charged, nobody seemed to know Stephen Rodriguez.
You know Mr. Rodriguez?
No.
No.
That takes balls, going to the house.
Yeah. Or fucking
sounds
bad
like the
job.
Reporter might have a fetish.
That'd be great. They'd grab the reporter, hold him down, and snake his ass.
Yeah. I'll give you an exclusive.
My ass was snaked as I tried to find Mr. Rodriguez.
Seems it's more to meet the eye.
Yeah, this story didn't end here.
No, it ended in my anus. And it goes on still.
I'm Ernie Anastas reporting from my bed at Columbia Presbyterian.
On my stomach.
At least I'm not a retard working at the bowling alley. Otherwise, in every other way.
Chris from Oklahoma City, they pull out the snake and there's just pennies and gum stuck to it.
Pennies and gum?
Jesus. We're supposed to be sad here, guys.
Oh,
yes. Come on. Yes,
that's maybe that's it. They were convinced there was something in his ass valuable or that they lost.
Oh, yeah, and they're just trying to
help
fish it out. Help a guy out.
I got
to
hear this guy again. Nah!
At the address police sources give for one of those charged, nobody seemed to know Stephen Rodriguez.
You know Mr. Rodriguez?
No.
Not at all?
No.
Police gave this address as where he lives.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't live here. I'm just visiting my sister.
What a shitty reporter.
What a great family.
No one seemed to know. I asked one man who had no reason to know.
Who are you? I'm just a plumber. I lost a tool here. I'm looking for my snake.
Somebody stole my snake.
I left it here.
Grass is where he lives.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I don't live here. I'm just visiting my sister.
Did your sister know Mr. Rodriguez?
I have no idea.
Does Mr. Rodriguez live here?
I just got here from Florida. I couldn't help you, dude.
And it's little wonder nobody admits knowing him. He is now charged in one of the most
horrific crimes in Florida. The guy instantly just accused him of lying.
And this lying sack of shit.
Do you still have to use Do you still have to use the news voice in a story like this?
I know. No one seems to know.
It's no wonder no one's saying he lives here. Listen to the reporter's voice.
Rodriguez live here?
I just got here from Florida. I couldn't help you, dude.
And it's little wonder nobody admits knowing him. He is now charged in one of the most horrific, one of the most heartless crimes in memory.
I don't know about heartless.
Yeah, I think that took a lot of heart. One holds them down, one does it, then they switch off.
Team effort.
Exactly.
Did he switch off your turn?
Yeah, come on. Yeah, man. I'm sick of holding him.
How does that
back
play
is sweaty.
Out?
Oh, I thought retards were strong. What a fucking docile nothing this guy was.
21 years old, too.
Yeah.
Of age, at least.
Yeah, at least that it wasn't.
Yeah, at least it wasn't.
Now they can claim it was consensual.
Yeah, we didn't know.
He said,
Okay, hey, I love you.
Hey, Anthony, don't we have audio of the attack?
Oh, I think we might.
We have an exclusive on our show.
Actually, you know, it wasn't that bad for him.
Right.
It sounds like a horrific thing to happen to somebody, but he actually worked there. He used to set the pins with his asshole.
Yeah.
So it really didn't hurt him that much as I looked for the proper sound. I'm never fucking
funny. I think there was some microphones in the bathroom.
What a lucky break.
What a lucky break.
Actually, I was thinking of other audio. No, I was thinking of audio before the act was committed.
Oh. I have no idea.
Let's see what's cooking in your room.
Her. Shit.
You mean it might have been that they wanted to check and see if he had some blockage of some sort?
Actually, it wasn't even the whole act. It was just the day. He didn't want to do it on that day.
It's out Friday wide.
Oh, Friday wide.
Announcing when he's going to shit, so.
Yeah.
What do you got cooking in your oven over here?
Can't really
That's
hear
a fake
our
laugh if I ever heard one.
Oh.
Alright, well, we got more details to the story.
Steve couldn't be happy about this.
And the most heinous act ever.
Heartless.
A mentally challenged man with a snake up his ass.
All right, more to the story here.
Of course.
A maintenance worker at the Shirley Lanes bowling alley, a 21-year-old developmentally disabled man, was followed into the bathroom here and savagely sexually assaulted with a mechanical plumbing device.
This guy's getting into it, man.
Yeah. Anyone else here?
Savagely sexually assaulted.
With a mechanical plumbing device. Oh, fuck. Lucky fella.
Plumbers gone wild.
A plumbing device.
Plumbing.
The assault caused severe internal injuries, and the victim was found bleeding on the floor. Charged in the attack were 19-year-old Stephen Rodriguez and 17-year-old Michael Lunsford, both from Shirley, and both men now charged with aggravated sexual assault in the first degree. No one with the bowling alley would talk with us on camera, but everyone here knows the victim, and everyone here now knows what happened to him. There are obvious and unpleasant echoes in this case, in the Abner Louima case, in which a police officer sexually assaulted a man with a stick. But this victim was developmentally disabled. He was just 21 years old.
And also the plumbing, they don't even make the connection.
No.
It wasn't a stick, it was a plunger.
It was a fucking
snake.
Yeah.
So it's like something about plumbing equipment makes people go, I gotta put something in. I gotta put this in somebody's ass. Something now. Like,
the toilet's clogged. Fuck. Need to grab something and shove it up some guy's ass.
Tim from Connecticut on the instant feedback. There's snakes in his motherfucking ass.
Snakes.
The fucking... Oh, wow.
You know how filthy those things are?
He had the mind of a 3-year-old and the asshole of a 38-year-old porn star.
Those things are filthy, too. You ever seen a plumber's snake thing? They don't sit there and clean them off.
No, they wipe them down with a rag for a minute.
Yeah.
It's not like they boil them afterwards.
Disgusting.
It's not meant for the anus.
And then to spin it a few times, those things have, like, blades on them.
Yeah.
If blades.
Well, if you're going to stick it in, you got to spin it.
You got to spin
what's
it.
What's the whole point?
Yeah, sticking it in without spinning it is just stupid.
Yeah, it's a waste of time.
What does it look like?
Dude, we're here. Let's spin the fucking thing.
Yeah. It comes on a big reel.
Yeah, I don't know what that looks like.
And it feeds out. It's almost
like
metal
a
conduit.
String.
Like a coil.
Yeah.
And then inside that coil is a cable.
Yep.
And on the end of it is some kind of a blade that spins, so you could crank away on this thing.
It's meant to cut through, you know, century-old shit that's
waste
built up in pipes.
And your pipe, and what you do is
or a retarded man's asshole.
Yeah. You feed it down the toilet as you crank the handle.
Or the retarded guy's asshole.
Or the retarded guy's asshole. And it cleans it out.
Yeah.
Dual purpose.
There you go, Jimmy.
There it is, Jimmy. Look at this thing.
I'm thinking these guys, by the way, didn't do well on their SATs.
Nah.
Oh, my God.
Why was the snake in the bathroom?
Well, maybe he had to go.
It's one of those things, like, they don't usually just have him laying around.
Well, he was probably going in there to fix a toilet. There was a toilet full of diarrhea and shit and tampons that he was fixing.
Oh, so you think he...
So they went in there and they improvised. They found... Yeah, they said, hey, let's use what he's using.
Oh. Well, they just saw the retarded man walking to the bathroom with the snake, and the one guy went, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Oh, my God.
Wow. And the one guy said, yeah. And then he goes, and as he's holding the guy down, putting it in his ass, the other guy's like, I just thought he wanted to turn the lights off and run. I didn't know we were going to rape another man who was developmentally disabled.
Johnny and Spionk. Johnny.
Hey, how you doing,
Jay? Hey, Johnny.
You ever been to this bowling alley? It's in Shirley. I mean, you talk about animals, and I'm not just the Spanish guy either. Just the white trash that's out there is terrible.
Yeah, Shirley is not really a nice place out on Long Island. Really,
oh, my God. It's like
where is that?
Brentwood.
Out exit 64. You know. Exit 64 of the expressway.
Around Waiting River, right?
Yeah.
It's somewhere. Yeah.
It's like the last bastion of, like, condos and things. And then you pass that and you're out, you know. You're out on the island.
Ish.
Wine country.
Right.
There's wine
well,
country.
Surely,
the retarded guy whining in the bathroom. About it. Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Johnny.
You got it.
Just a horrific story today.
Ugh.
All right.
Well,
and to think
God
his
bless.
Life was going so great, too.
Yeah.
Retarded guy working at a bowling alley.
It's Shirley.
And Shirley, God, what a far tumble that was for him.
He's the only guy who ever had a snake in his asshole, and it actually took him up on the social ladder.
Yeah, well, I was on the radio. I heard I was on Opie Anthony, too. It was kind of cool.
I got rid of Todd, a guy with a snake up his ass in Shirley. Bigger than you.
All right, we're going to break. Louis C.K. in studio today. Trump Marina Saturday.
Saturday night.
And Otto and George tonight at Comics here in New York City.
Yep.
C-O-M-I-X.
On 14th Street in the Meatpacking District with Nina Hartley.
There you go.
All right.
Now getting your nails done could wind up doing a lot of damage.
How bad will the hurricanes be?
A popular medicine for children now linked to 7 deaths.
A common medicine could be turning people into compulsive gamblers.
And is there a hidden danger in your bag of microwave popcorn?
Stop it!
Are your local reporters trying to scare you to death? The Opie and Anthony Show wants to hear scary news teases from your town. Send your audio to Danny at FoundryMusic.com. That's Danny at FoundryMusic.com.
talking about stingrays today.
Are we?
Yeah, I think we are now.
Because we hadn't up until now. And that almost sounded like we'd been talking about them all day.
I want them to think they missed something.
Oh, okay. See, I tore
smart,
down the
right?
eighth wall.
Another stingray story.
Yeah, these things are getting a little uppity.
Mm-hmm.
The stingrays.
It's all about the stingrays now.
Wait, so a stingray jumped in a guy's boat and...
Yeah, apparently.
Stabbed him in the heart.
And stabbed him in the heart. How scary
is that? Yeah, this is war now.
Yeah.
Like, we're at war with the stingray population.
And we're losing.
Now yeah. they're coming up where we breathe.
Exactly.
That's bad.
Exactly.
An 81-year-old man survives a stingray attack similar to the one that killed crocodile hunter Steve Irwin. Stingray jumped into his boat off the coast of Florida, then stung him in the chest. The leaping ray left a foot-long barb in the man's chest. He underwent surgery to have it removed. He's expected to make a full recovery. Wildlife experts say this was a very unusual attack, and they say stingrays are normally peaceful animals.
All right, keep saying that.
Yeah. Yeah,
keep saying it.
You should see what two stingrays did in a bathroom in Shirley, New York.
In the boat.
Jumped up into the boat.
Take that, cocksucker.
Jumped out again.
How does the 80-year-old guy get stabbed in the chest, and he lives, and this stupid Aussie is, like, in shape, or... You know, running around the outback.
Fucking dies.
Yeah, he dies from the same thing.
By the way, we all got our copies of The Bridge. The director is coming in tomorrow. The poster looks even good.
I'm very jealous of my company here for that.
What, you got your copy, though?
No, it's coming in about 20 minutes.
Oh, okay. We were talking about this over at Free FM today. The director of The Bridge is coming in. How many deaths? 24?
I think 23 20? Out of 24, something
four.
Like that.
Yeah, said 24. Boink, boink, boink. Fates of 24 people who died at the Golden Gate Bridge in 2004, linked together by a four-second fall, but their lives have been moving on a parallel tracks and similar arcs all along. Because they kind of look into these people. You know, it would be kind of like a lunatics gone wild if they just showed people jumping.
Yeah.
You know?
Here's a guy.
Yeah, check out this nut.
And with my do-do-do.
Yeah.
We're gonna actually...
They just play this a bunch of times. That would be wacky, but they kind of get into these people's lives and what
he wants us to feel
final
for these
moment,
people, right?
On the Golden Gate Bridge.
Yeah.
Apparently, this guy did his research and realized, hey, about that many people, 24 or 25 or so, every year kill themselves on the Golden Gate Bridge. It's been happening for years. If I set up a camera and just keep it rolling constantly, I'm going to catch people killing
what
themselves.
What a great idea.
Brilliant.
So he did that and made a movie about it. Wow. Very controversial.
Yeah, the movie is so fucking long because it's in real time.
I'm going to do a movie where I
kill Wow.
Oh, okay.
That joke.
I heard somebody else did a movie where they set up a camera in a bathroom in a bowling alley in Shirley. And
see how many they catch.
Was, there are like 50 rapings.
Finally got pay dirt.
At the end of the year, you find out.
Yeah.
Fucking constant.
A whole
fucking
year of people peeing and throwing out garbage.
Guy's been taking a year. He took the camera out the day before yesterday. Fuck. Nothing happens here.
All right. Let's say hi to Casper. Hey, Casper.
Hey, guys, what's going on?
What's up?
I was watching Mythbusters last night.
Yeah.
They were talking about jumping off bridges and stuff, and they tried to throw the dummy off the Golden Gate Bridge, and they weren't allowed to.
They couldn't because he was in the bathroom having his asshole snaked.
Dummy.
So what they did was they dropped him from 150 feet off a crane, that dummy they got, and they measured like almost 300 Gs on your body when you hit the water.
Oof. That could do some damage, I'm thinking.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Almost as bad as a snake up your butt.
I'm thinking maybe a broken nose.
Yes, later.
Perhaps a bit more than that, Opie.
Perhaps a road rash.
That was a myth?
Yeah, I know. What myth
were they busting? Happens.
Well, they're running out of myths.
Yeah. Mythbusters was doing like myths that were urban legends, things that everybody knew, and now they're kind of like scrambling for things.
Yeah,
there's a myth that if you jump off the Golden Gate Bridge, you could be killed.
Let's find out.
I think that's a myth. So they take a dummy, like a crash test dummy,
yeah,
and throw it off and get all kinds of readings off of it.
Apparently.
Yeah. Mm, wow.
The data shows...
This was really surprising. Your head would cave in.
Your head would become part of Uranus.
Yeah, it'd turn inside out.
Now someone is arguing, saying the ray didn't jump out of the boat. There's no way the ray would have jumped out of the boat. It just can't happen.
What do you mean jumped out of the boat?
In the boat.
Jumped into the boat.
Well, Oh, out of the water into the boat. There you go. Okay.
Maybe he was fishing, and he had it on the line, and gave it a good tug, and came onto the boat. I don't know.
I don't know either.
They never give you enough details on those stories.
No. We want all the details.
Everyone.
Want
the video.
All right, so the guy from the bridge will be in tomorrow.
That's probably on YouTube already.
That's going to be great. I can't wait. And I can't wait to see the movie tonight. I got it.
I don't know if I'm...
For free.
I don't like things like that.
I not only do I
sex
like them,
is
I
great.
Them.
I
don't
watch
like watching the violence stuff.
Smut and stuff. Jimmy will go to, like, ogrish.com and those sites and watch the beheadings and things like that. No, show me Jap girl with shit coming out her ass in a wedding dress.
Amen.
And I'll watch it 80 times.
Hey, look, does
it
mean... I watched some of those Iraq beheadings.
Oh, you did?
It's horrific.
Yeah, it's disturbing on a very...
The weirdest part, though, is how it always ends with they show the guy's head and he's got this dumb look on his face. Like,
oh, God. Oh, God.
Look on the dude's face.
It's like a sitcom husband.
He was
husband.
Just screaming and screaming, and then he just looks like, boom.
It's like one eye kind of open. Yeah, that's really a drag, man.
Nah, that's my edge. I can't go there.
Wow.
The worst never thing.
I haven't seen him, so, you know, I don't
it's
even.
Just
you guys
worst.
Know how nutty my ex-girlfriend is. They know Erin, my ex-girlfriend. She's crazy, and she's very funny, and she's nuts. And nothing fucking bugs this chick.
Yeah.
She was over my part one time. She, I want to see these videos. I'm like, you don't want to see this.
No.
She got me to go to one. I'm like, okay. I put it on,
it's
and she
in
was
your
watching
brain
for
forever.
30 seconds. She screamed.
Yeah, it's horrible.
She physically did a, oh, and fucking had to walk away from the computer.
Worst thing ever.
It's the worst thing I've ever seen.
Yep. Then you fucked the shit out of her.
Yeah, actually, while we were doing it.
That's why she screamed.
How'd
Jimmy stuck it in her ass?
I never made her feel good in bed. I'm like, you are going to make a noise tonight. Watch this.
Wow. That's a whole new form. Make girls watch beheading videos while you fuck them.
While you're dogging her.
Oof. If they dry shivers. Up, they get the same.
Let's try to sell that to NBC. I think we have a hit on our hands.
Yeah, but any of that shit, like the grotesque horrible. People like, hey, this guy jumped off a fucking building. Check out this picture. It's like, no. I like that. The sex stuff, anything goes. I've watched that guy get killed by the horse, and that's kind of, the guy's dying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the horse is fucking him. Yeah. Come on. That kind of outdoes the dying part.
Exactly. Right. You feel sad, yet you have a raging erection.
you said a Japanese girl with shit coming out of her ass is...
Yeah.
That's good.
It's not good. It's not good, like, holy shit,
what's
I gotta
wrong with
see
just
this.
A Japanese girl? Why does it have to be feces involved?
Because that was one I saw.
Oh,
and,
okay.
Like, that stuff won't grow. It'll gross me out. Like, I'll be like, oh, that's disgusting, but I can watch it.
Yeah,
oh,
he's trying to explain how far he could go.
Yeah, that's like
stuff.
How far it goes, but it's all sex stuff.
Oh, I see.
Like, I can't take violent. I like watching fights. Mm-hmm. Like, that stuff. You go onto YouTube and, you know, you watch two guys just beating the shit out of each other. That's fine, too. But when it comes to, like, people
some of the ultimate
killing.
Fighting I can't watch.
And I can also watch our troops, videos of our troops killing insurgents.
Really?
There's one of, I guess, a helicopter gunship just ripping apart about five guys. One guy's trying to hide under a truck, and it's night vision.
They got footage. Wow, cool.
And he crawls out a little bit, and you hear the guy go, hit him, hit him. And... And you see pieces because it's a heat signature. So you see hot pieces of this guy go flying on the street, and that doesn't bother me because again, I don't know him, and it's far away.
Not you,
and it's not real enough. You know, it's almost video game-ish.
Mm-hmm. Only videos I couldn't watch on Obrish, and I could not do it. It was a 4-part series of a guy torturing a kitten.
What the fuck?
It was.
You could watch a beheading, but not kitten
not
abuse.
A kitten
I don't know why.
Little kitties.
I don't know why I couldn't watch. Not that I judge one is worse than the other. I just
humans aren't innocent of anything. Animals are all innocent.
Oh,
maybe.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah.
Fuck off.
Sweet.
Well, yeah, because the guy.
fuck off.
I thought we were getting some insight in it.
Fuck off.
I like kittens. Yours.
I like cute kittens, you cunt. Yeah.
Fuck off. Your mother's cunt. These are a few of my favorite things. But no, I don't know if it's a love for animals. I just couldn't watch it. I saw part one of it because I hated the guy doing it so much. Mm. He didn't really hurt the kitten in the first one. He spun it around. He was fucking with it badly.
Oh, God.
But they said it was graphic animal torture, and I couldn't watch the three parts. Couldn't do it.
Why would you do it?
I couldn't
why
do it.
Would you watch it?
He
why
went to
would...
jail, though. This would bug the only thing that bugged me at Ogre.
They don't get much time, no.
No,
they get,
like,
this is in Belgium. A
couple of months.
But Ogre's took the videos down because of complaints from PETA, and it's like, that was kind of odd. Like,
there are beheadings.
Like, you'll leave the beheadings.
PETA's like, fuck the Iraqi beheadings. Yeah.
But that was the most.
I like that they kowtow to PETA, too, of all things.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
The relatives of the beheaded. Yeah. Excuse me. You whore.
Could you take my son's death off of your site, please?
Fuck you. Wait a minute. Cindy Crawford's on the line? Yeah. Oh, no. Or whoever.
They're consistent. They're protecting animals.
You know, the shower.
Let me tell you something, though. Those kittens are adorable.
Yeah. Yep. The shower scene in Psycho, they were more upset with the shot of a toilet bowl than they were of the stabbing of Jared Lee.
Yep.
They didn't want the toilet shown.
Why?
No. There's something about the bodily functions that was a problem.
Yeah, don't
problem
remind me that I shit toilet every day.
Yeah. Kill a girl who hasn't wanted to.
No, that's true.
They've had problems with bathrooms and mentioning bathrooms in TV for years.
Yeah.
Everyone knows the water closet story with Jack Parr, I guess it was. Jack Parr got in trouble for saying water closet on the old Tonight Show. He was talking about something in the bathroom, not even going to the bathroom. Oh. He said water closet and got in all kinds of trouble saying that. Imagine it's a fucking how uptight
stick up your ass in this freaking country.
Yeah. All right, let's go to Matt in Dallas. What's up, Matt?
Hey, I don't know if you've seen this Japanese video with the Japanese girl with the eagles. You all seen that?
With the what?
With the eels.
Yeah, I've seen
eels coming out of her. Yeah.
We saw one on Pal Talk before with a squid falling out of a pussy, which is horrible.
Yeah, a whole squid just shoved in there, and it looks like she's shitting it out, but it's coming out of her pussy.
Alive?
And the squid is using three of its tentacles to hold its nose.
Fucking, that was a weird water skiing accident or something. Fucking squid run.
All right, guys.
Straight up her snatch. Damn it.
Oh. All right.
Yeah, friend used to feed kittens. That's one thing. That's sick, too. Feeding kittens to a snake if you have a pet, like, python that's 18 feet long.
Yeah.
That's one thing, and you got to have a weird head for that. But even that doesn't equal the torture and, like, slow killing of an innocent little animal that's all cute and everything.
I saw one.
A fucking water buffalo you could just beat over the head all day with a sledgehammer. Like, who gives a shit?
I actually jerk off watching the last scene of Apocalypse Now.
And they're just cutting apart that fucking water buffalo.
Nobody cares.
No one cares. Kittens, though, their foreheads are too big for their face. It's adorable.
That's funny.
I'll tell you an awful one I saw, and I didn't know how bad this was because on Consumption Junction. There was two guys who, again, I would just love to strangle these guys. And there was a cat inside of, like, a little cage that it couldn't move in. It was, like, trapped in this little cage. And they doused it with fucking gas and set it on fire and videotaped it. It was awful, the sounds it was making. It was horrible. I can't comprehend doing that.
You don't have to watch these, Jimmy.
I know.
And watching them, I think, is affecting you, even though you don't think it is.
Maybe. Yeah, that's why I don't watch that. I mean, I watch those beheadings and I regret it.
Yeah.
And I don't watch that stuff anymore.
I had nightmares over those.
The closest I saw of a beheading was a still picture of the head on the guy's back.
Yeah.
How they put it on the back. Yeah. I saw one still picture of that for a split second, and the image is still too clear in my head.
No, I remember every detail from those things. Yeah.
See, it fucks you up, Jimmy.
Yeah, it does.
Jimmy.
Yeah.
Jimmy.
Don't do it.
I should watch happier videos.
Yeah.
I don't know. Where's the old shit in the mouth stuff I used to download?
The good old days.
The happy days.
Otto, can you watch that stuff?
I've never seen a beheading video.
Yeah.
I remember seeing that guy shoot himself in the mouth.
Our bud Dwyer.
That stayed with me for a couple of days.
That was a bad one.
The worst thing about the beheading was, like, the guy screaming, and then they cut his throat, so you hear it goes from hearing his voice to just hearing wind coming out, just fucking air coming out.
Really?
God damn.
He was gasping for he couldn't breathe, obviously.
Yeah.
He just
becomes lungs pushing air out.
See, that's even bad enough. Like, you're just saying this?
Yeah,
I can't take
it. It was horrible.
Oh, man.
Not even in a funny way. It was, like, disturbing on, like,
in a
deeply
funny way.
Not even funny.
No, but I mean,
that's how bad it was.
Not like when you get goofy.
You know, if they had put a clown hat on him,
that's what his family. That's what his family said at the funeral. Dude, that wasn't even funny. At least if it had been funny.
Did you even laugh?
No, I gotta tell you, I didn't. Well, I gotta be honest with you.
It wasn't even funny.
Didn't even laugh.
You know what I mean?
Brian from Grand Rapids. Hey, Opie, Phil with Norm audio on Daily Show. I sent it to Steve. Is that the Norm McDonald?
Yeah, that's what Show is the thing I saw. Yeah.
Oh, okay. We should. You were just talking about that during the break, so we should maybe play that. Maybe Steve could bring that in. NFL Stadium terror threat. Yes.
What?
This is.
Maybe you were right. Maybe you did see sharpshooters. Huh? So you said you saw sharpshooters.
No one wanted to listen to me the other day.
Where'd you go? He said he saw sharpshooters on the roof of Giant Stadium, and some guy called him and goes, there is no roof on Giant Stadium. And then we got to explain that there is a little perimeter. And, you got to explain the dumbest things to people, to the dumbest dummies.
I love that he called. I'm going to call, because that's a slight error in vernacular.
We get it every day.
There ain't a roof
every day.
Terrorists threatening to target seven NFL games this Sunday. Homeland Security officials aren't putting much stock behind the online threat, but they're still warning stadiums from New Jersey to Seattle to be on alert. Fox 5's Catherine Craig is in East Rutherford right now with more. So what is this threat, Catherine?
Well, Lucy, basically it's an internet posting warning that those seven stadiums that you just saw from here at the Meadowlands to Seattle,
and that
Cincinnati, down
sucked.
In Houston, basically that they will be hit with dirty bombs. If you have tickets, though, for games at any of those stadiums, local and national elected leaders are saying that you should go and you should feel safe. Right now, Homeland Security says you can't
feel safe.
So why are you talking about and increased patrols at Giant Stadium and the six other NFL stadiums around the country.
You should go.
Exactly.
I shouldn't be saying that.
I felt safe until I turned the TV on this morning.
It's one dirty bomb and it's on the end of a plumber snake.
The department says it issued the warning just to be cautious, but Homeland Security is skeptical about the validity of the threat. The internet posting was discovered a week ago. Local Congressman Peter King, who also runs the Homeland Security Committee, says if you're going to the Meadowlands this weekend for the Jets game, you should feel safe.
Buying tickets for the game on Sunday, I go to the game. I mean, I'm very confident nothing's going to happen.
But
on the other hand, in the world in which we live today, every threat has to be looked at, and we have to be cautious. We have to be prudent.
You want tickets? No, I'd go to the game.
And the people who run Giant Stadium, where we are, tell us this is a well-protected fortress. They already have advanced security screening systems in place.
How do you get me to be cautious and go at the same
they
time?
They scared you.
Yeah.
But yet told you everything's fine.
You should totally go.
Then why talk about it?
There's threats out there. They're not credible. Go to the game.
Go to the game.
Have fun.
Homeland Security guy said if he had tickets, he'd go.
Yeah. When was the last time they detonated a bomb in this country? Like, never? I mean, it was like...
Yeah, not legitimately. Yeah. It was one of our own.
But now you have that in the back of your head. Thanks.
Thanks.
Thanks to the news.
Dirty bomb.
Yeah.
It's even worse. No, that's the only thing that ever happened.
Yeah.
September 11th. Except for the thing that one of our guys did.
Yeah, the domestic shit with the Unabomber.
Also,
the
93 Trace bomb, and they just didn't do right.
Yeah, what?
The Unabomber was just targeting certain people, though. Yeah. He didn't go to, like, crowded stadiums.
Right. He was all right.
This is awful to say.
He was all right.
Allegedly awful to say. But, the you know, September 11th and how Ground Zero is hallowed ground.
Yeah.
Do we have to pretend that there were no assholes in those buildings? There wasn't, like,
yeah,
a
not
single
one
shithead.
Fucking asshole.
Like, before it happened, I never stopped at those buildings and went, oh, keep it up, you sweethearts. Love that place and everyone in it. Hope nothing ever happens to them.
And every
favorite people, those two buildings.
Yeah. Every couple was in love. Right?
Yeah.
There was definitely probably a vicious divorce case.
There wasn't one couple
not
that was
a single asshole.
A day away from filing divorce. Yeah.
Do you think there was one bitter ex-husband who went, look, it's a tragedy, but, you know, she was a cunt.
Yeah. I took out a couple of Janine Garofalo fans up there.
Yeah, in hindsight, with enough time by, you can bring that up, you know. I'm sure there were a few pricks working there.
I always don't measure, like, I think you can measure how bad a person you are by how soon you masturbated after the planes hit. Like, what's the first time?
Before
was it like a month after?
For me, it was
between the two buildings collapsing, which is probably the bad sign that I had to. I had to, because otherwise they win, you know, the terrorists.
Right.
You gotta go on with our lives. Keep shopping, keep jerking off, don't let them win.
It's true.
Keep it up.
Jerry.
Yeah.
Hi, Jer.
Jimmy, I have a question for you, my idol.
Okay.
Last night I had an escort service come to the hotel room, and she charged me $100. I don't know, we just kind of sat around and talked for a little bit, and then we got down to business. She gave out prices. First was 40 for a blowjob, 80 for just sex. And
where'd you find this fucking bargain?
Denver.
Oh, well, wait, funny. I'll be there next week.
So it was 40 for a blowjob, 80 for sex. What was the 100 for?
Just for having
everything. Blowjob and sex.
Wait, is that in addition to the 100 or no?
No, it was just 40 for the blow job, and then it was jumped up to 80 for sex, and then it was just 100 for both.
What the fuck is this question?
What's the question?
Yeah, what is your
question?
What'd
she look like? Was she awful?
I'm telling everybody.
The question is great. It says, Jim, is $100 too much for a hooker?
Dude, that's not even close to enough. Because I don't know. I'm afraid of diseases are getting robbed. So, I mean, I paid more than that for hand jobs. But again, is it more too much for a hooker? No. No, it's not. I paid $7 and two cigarettes once to get blown by a chick on the way home from Plainfield, New Jersey when I was like 20.
But you eat raw cashews.
Yeah, I'm trying to eat healthy now. But
I think what you could do with that $7 if you had it today.
Those cigarettes. Those cigarettes. Thank God my lungs are a little healthier. Here.
Well, I've never done such a thing like that, and I figured, well,
such
I want to be like my idol.
Never done such
way
a thing.
Way to describe
such
a 1932
thing.
Vernacular.
I've never done such a thing.
Well, I never.
Put my monocle back in and...
Yeah. Never. That's right. Monocle. And bring my slave.
You and your whole fucking family, Carleone.
So was it good for you, Jerry?
Yeah, I think it was worth my half hour.
Half hour? Was she hot?
Half hour. Stood about five, six, maybe 110
pounds. 8 stone.
15 hands high.
Nice little quirky titties. And...
Where was she from? Was she from down the road a spell?
Good set of teeth.
Like he's trying to sell a Negro.
I am, by the way.
Jerry?
Hello?
Yeah.
So, I think your answer is no, it's not too much for a
hooker.
Why is
Norton your idol? For his comedy skills or for just liking prostitutes?
Or C, both.
Yeah.
Besides Opie and Anthony being funny, he's the funniest comedian that comes in.
Right.
Thank you. Well, I'm not coming in. I'm here. He's here. He's.
Well,
why don't you ask him about Richard Pryor or something? What are you asking about hookers for you?
Yeah.
Creep.
I don't know, because Jimmy is an expert on that subject.
Well, he's got a point.
His parents are listening.
Yes.
Fucking asshole.
Yes. and my father, see, my father would probably say 100 is too much for a blowjob, but Mom would say no, it's not.
Yeah.
Mom would say
anything
ass
for you, Jimmy.
Only if ass play involved.
Jimmy, wouldn't your mom say you have a nice gym downstairs?
A nice one.
Oh,
wow, you're bombing.
Actually, though, it's funny. I did take Mom's advice, and that's why I started working out. Mom's advice changed my life.
It's way back.
Forgot about that.
Yeah.
Mommy loves
you. We just remember the voicemail, but I forgot that it led to you actually working
out. My mother left me a voicemail. She heard me on the show one time talking about prostitutes.
Yeah. Wait, Louis, have you ever heard this?
What? No.
It's 30 seconds?
We haven't played this in a while. We got it.
It's a real voicemail from my mother that I saved and put on my CD.
And she had heard you talking about prostitutes
hookers
on the radio.
On this show.
Yes. So how did that lead to working out?
Well, I'll tell you, this is the voicemail she left
me.
It's a real voicemail. She was like really embarrassed I played it.
They're running around. No one's really working behind the scenes today.
You remember one time when Jimmy and I were working on my show, and Jerry Minor, who played my neighbor across the hall, we were all eating bacon. There's, you know, there's always a table of just bacon, a whole table. And we're just eating it, and I'm just making myself sick. And I'm like, oh, God, I fucking hate myself. Just eating bacon, making my body hate me more. And Jim does one of his corny things. He says, everything in moderation, Lou. And then so I said, really, everything? Like, that goes for anything? Like fucking your mom in the ass in moderation? And then I said that, and then Jerry Minor, like, does a motion of a mother getting fucked in the ass and goes, not too much now, dear. Like your mom telling you.
Oh, shit. We got the phone call? Oh, we got it now? All right, so this is really Jim's mom leaving a voice. A
couple years ago.
I want to cry.
I know. I want to cry. That's the best mother I ever heard.
Is she nice? Yeah.
When you listen to how she says, though, don't be mad at me. Like, he goes home and, what the fuck did you do, bitch?
Like, but it's so sweet. And you picture it playing while, you know, like in Apocalypse Now, you're laying there dead like Clean's paper.
Oh, God.
Anyway, sweet, you're laying there riddled by bullets.
That's with your hiney out of the way of the bullets.
Can't bring your hiney home.
Oh, damn, that's good.
We're going to get you a new car, but that's a secret. And avoid prostitutes.
Ha, ha.
Yeah. Just ha, ha. That laugh.
Bullet-riddled body.
Oh, that's so nice.
See what he was protecting? It was a fucking hooker.
Oh, my God, that's so sweet.
Yeah.
I like also just like every mother of a grown person that it starts with, hey, everybody's fine.
Everybody's fine.
You just know your mother calls. Every time I see my mother, so who's dead?
Yeah.
Otherwise, don't fucking bother
me,
Mom.
Death call.
Yeah. We get along really good, though. I mean, my parents are like really cool. They like that.
She's right, too. She's that's good advice.
They love the show, and my dad loves the sex stories. He doesn't care. But she was right. I did take the advice. I was like, God damn, my mother.
I didn't think you were going to take the advice. See, that's what a mother hears her son talking about, like, you know, shitting in hookers' mouths, and she just thinks, he needs to exercise, my boy.
I think that's what he needs.
Isn't that fantastic?
That is so awesome.
The innocent ignorance of a mom.
No, that's the way they think. They'll defend any boy.
Yep. She said at one point, she goes, you know, you'll tone up, and because she was kind of saying, look, I do understand why you have to pay for it, but maybe if you crush his fat tits, score a little free box. That was loving mother's way of saying
exactly.
Oh, you think that that's what you meant?
Put the money into a health club.
Yeah.
You'll
meet some people.
You might get to fuck somebody who's not chewing gum while you're...
Yeah, maybe if your tits weren't showing in an XL shirt, you'd meet a girl for free, fat fuck. You and your deep belly button.
And you've been working out ever since?
Yeah, man. I hate when I miss it now. I did yesterday. I hit the heavy bag a lot. Now I did fucking 10 rounds in a bag. And, a little
bit. How many pounds?
I don't weigh myself. I don't know.
I don't do that either. I work out, but I don't care about that.
I just kind of like want to see where my stomach is at, and it's all eating, and it's hard to eat right, man. It's fucking...
I just do it to feel better. I just do it to have stamina and feel like a person.
You know, a massage therapist in LA changed me too. Yeah. I was in LA shooting Luckily, and I went to a massage therapist one time, and she wouldn't jerk me. She wasn't her thing, but she would have for like 1,000. And I was like, that's crazy. And as she's massaging me, she goes, you know, she said something about you might want to exercise. She was just trying to exercise because she goes, you don't want to be the guy that girls just fuck for money. And she was basically saying, like, look at you. Because I was heavy when we were shooting.
Wow. But you were close enough. Here's the thing. You were close enough to be told that. Because she's not going to tell every fucking disgusting guy that. Because he's going to die that way.
No, that was pure.
But she looks at you and she goes, if he worked out, he could just crawl over to the other side of only fucks for money.
No, that was pure rage because she's an ex-fat girl and she was really trying to hurt my feelings.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because she had a little dog running around the hall.
How do you know she was ex-fat?
She told me she lost a lot of weight. And here's a word of advice. If you're going to get a massage, you're not going to get jerked off if they're allowing their small dog to run through the apartment. That's never going to fucking end with a fucking load being shot.
So you went to her apartment for the massage?
Yeah, but
how are you not just going to strangle her?
She didn't, but I guess she didn't have a doorman.
Oh.
She didn't even have a doorman.
She didn't know.
But now it actually turned out to be an okay massage, and she'll never know, but she helped me.
Did you give her $1,000 for the jerk?
No, I wouldn't give her $1,000 for an ass fuck and $800 back.
Oh.
Let's go to Trisha, Alabama. Trisha.
Bama. Hi.
Hey.
Hi, I'm a truck driver. I weigh 420. My husband's been trying to feed me to get up to, like, 441.
Yeah.
And we got a load coming, leaving Monday out of California up to New York.
It's called Trisha.
When your husband goes food shopping and puts the groceries away, does he have to hire a rodeo clown to distract you?
No, he's been feeding me all the truck food.
That pig selfish fool?
He's been feeding me all them truck stop food like that cowboy.
Rotten oinker.
Let me explain what's going on here. Trisha is 420 pounds, and our current leader in the Fatty Pig Fatty contest is 430, so she's stuffing her face because she wants to win the contest.
Yeah. My husband said we can use that money, so he's been trying to feed me all the time, and I'm just about puking. Mm. He got ding dongs in the truck, and he's been
got ding dongs in the truck. Sounds like a metaphor for something.
He's got ding dongs in the truck, if you know what I'm saying.
After an August run in that truck, her seat must smell like a fucking Haitian refugee tent.
You douche?
I was kind of saying that your butt cracked just from being sweaty. Yeah, no disrespect. Yeah, yeah.
Well, I can reach back there still.
Oh, God.
You can? That's great.
Barely.
You'll be in the Olympics soon.
Biscuits and gravy.
That's amazing.
She could wipe her ass on her way to a gold.
Yeah.
She's going to be fucking getting shot put gold. Oh, shit.
So you guys coming to New York?
Yeah, we're supposed to deliver there Wednesday.
You got
to
bring her in through the tunnel like those elephants.
When the circus comes in.
She has to hold on to the tail.
They got to close the Lincoln Tunnel to walk her through.
Oh, God.
Oh, just eating hay and shit while she's talking.
Those are impact tremors.
Oh. We're teasing, wow. Darling.
Yeah, of course.
So when are you coming in?
On Wednesday.
Wednesday, okay. Yeah. A lot of girls promising to come in next week. We'll see what happens.
We hear a lot of talk. We don't see a lot of fat.
That's right.
So come in.
Come on in.
We'll be nice to you.
You'll have fun either way.
$10 a pound.
Yeah, we're good like that.
All right.
Okay. Enjoy dying young.
Okay, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Hold on the line. We'll give you some info.
Otto had a really great line one time. I think it was like a really fat woman walking, and we were doing the walkover, and Otto says, "Do you like to play peekaboo with your Grim Reaper?" Oh, is that a good one?
Maybe you should give him like 12 a pound or something. You know, it's pretty humiliating when you're ass creep on them.
Yeah.
We are, but you know what?
There's a finder's fee, too.
Fuck yeah, $1,000, and they get $10 a pound, 400-something pounds, that's $4,500.
It's like a big game hunter.
Just to be you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You get a finder's fee for bringing this slob down.
And, we, put and their face would be obscured the whole time,
by a pig mask.
By a pig mask.
And a horse like people that used to take rich guys in the 1800s to go find game and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to see a very fat woman, right? Oh, yes, boss. I'm going to show you a very fat pig.
Yes. Yeah.
She's a truck driver.
Buona, see big fat woman.
Yeah. White hunter, fat fuck.
This show, you know, we're like the guy in the Elephant Man that brought the people to laugh at John Merrick and drink and pour alcohol on him.
And what was wrong with him?
And nothing at all.
Nothing.
I love when he gets his shaving kit and he opens it and he tries to comb his hair and dab on cologne.
Because he's a classy guy.
Yeah. He wants to go meet the princess.
That huge head.
He died sleeping. What a zilch.
He just finally wanted to live.
Just wanted to live. Just wanted to sleep on a pillow like the boy in the picture.
All right, listen. God, Norm McDonald. Actually, you brought this up during the break, but they were listening to us on Pal Talk, so now maybe we should do this. You said Norm McDonald and the Stingrays, really funny on
the joke on the
On what, the Daily Show?
Yeah, the Daily Show.
This was sent in by Brian from Grand Rapids, Michigan.
I wanted to talk about the crocodile hunter.
Did you?
Because I think...
Yeah, you're going to make him sad.
Because I think, you know, it was tragic at the time. Yeah, yeah. But I think... I don't know, people calling me, man, they're shocked. Oh, hey, you wouldn't believe it, who got killed? The crocodile hunter. Please don't make me laugh at this. He was 44 years old. I'm like, that's a ripe old age for a crocodile hunter. And you know who had to be pissed about it were the crocodiles, because he got killed by some fruity fish. So the crocodiles were like, hey, man, that crocodile hunter got killed. Who did it, Frank? You don't even want to know, man. No, Bill, man, you had a chance. Like the guy go, man, I had a chance. I had that motherfucker. He was Tommy the Stick. I could have eat him and his kid. I don't feel good about this. You remember I ever tell you that story, Bill? Yeah, only a 1,000 times. That's for the kids. All right, Norm McDonald, we're putting
that is goddamn funny.
Damn it.
Hilarious.
Very funny. Jimmy, did you let one out?
No. Yeah, I smelled that shit, man.
Oh. Come on, Jimmy.
Yeah, come on, Jimmy.
What time is it?
Oh, it's bad.
He gets scared.
We need nervous. All the guys made me nervous.
I need something.
This is from the soup.
Please,
okra soup over
Thank
here.
You, Dan.
Disgusting.
Spray it in your eyes. God, fucking Febreze.
I didn't see shit. I didn't see shit on the menu. shit puree. Wow.
All right.
Okay. That's good. Much better. Spray it right into the mic and then just smell the mic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like being a fucking one of those CSI guys where you got to put the Vicks under your nose because the body's been rotting for 3 months.
No,
that's what comes out of Jimmy's ass.
Farting in a soundproof room. It's not nice.
No.
You guys want to talk to Patty before we get out of here?
Oh. Patty. Patty's here?
Yeah.
What is she here for?
Couple minutes.
I got a Pelt Talk shirt.
And then we're going to do line of the day and get the hell out of here.
Patty, by the way, is a 51-year-old, I guess she is now, 51-year-old virgin. She has never had sex in her life.
Oh, why would the mic be on?
Yeah, wait till the mic's on. When you hold the mic, could you cup the bottom of it?
Sorry.
I want to see what it would look like. No, I mean, she has no idea where the balls would be. Where would balls be on that if that was a cock?
Here.
No.
It's right in the middle of the shaft.
In the middle of your shaft are your balls, people.
Like a twig.
If they hang any lower, please get to an emergency room. Your balls belong in the middle of
right
your dick.
Below the head.
You stupid ass. Don't you understand they'd be...
I haven't seen too much of that.
That shaft, let's say, is an entire cock. Where would the balls be?
With an XM box on the top.
Now cup underneath.
Like that?
There you go. There you go.
Now, yes, like both, like you're praying
that it would stop, because it's your uncle, and you're 12.
Yeah.
Now, what are you here for? Anything special?
No, just went over for the walkover, haven't been for a little while, and worked a lot of mornings.
Yeah.
So I had my first day off in about 6 days, so I decided to do the walkover.
Why didn't you go to Atlantic City? Take the jitney.
I haven't been there in a while.
No?
Only that's once in a very, very blue moon.
You're on a losing streak? 51 years?
That's right.
Yeah. You go there and play the
spot. How was your drive back from Cleveland? I remember talking to you about that.
Oh. It was nice.
Yeah.
Drive back from Cleveland.
Nice 8-hour trip.
It's nice. Yeah.
On a bus?
No, in a car.
Yeah.
With Pat Munaki and with no filter Paul.
Why are you talking like you're digital and it's breaking up? With Pat from Munaki and Paul?
Yeah.
Oof. What were you doing in Cleveland?
I was at the virus show.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was in the petting zoo, which I loved. That was so cute.
They put a few of the pests in the petting zoo and people got to spit on them and do whatever they want to.
No, people were like going like, petting the top of my head and go on.
Did you get those fucking gums, Chernobyl?
God damn it.
Yeah, I know. Doesn't it look like rolled up Hubba Bubba and Chiclets?
Yeah, and I even got to be Miss Virus at the PNC Bank Arts Center.
Well, that was a joke.
Yeah. Oh, I know. Oh, my God. I didn't even know.
You know when people were petting your hair, they were giving you stink finger first and then petting you on the head?
No.
Yeah. Your head smelt like a plumber snake in Shirley.
No, it didn't.
Oh, God.
Anything else?
Anything,
No,
How's work going in your life?
Yeah, I just got my first raise.
Oh, you got a raise?
Almost perfect rating on my evaluation.
Where are you working now?
What do you do?
At Starbucks.
Oh, yeah.
What do they evaluate you on?
Oh, your work performance and everything. And out of a 3.0, which is the highest you can go, I had a 2.9 something.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's mediocre. Everyone does that.
Yeah, what do they want you to work on?
But, you know. That'll get you late eventually.
Oh, just be a little faster at the drink bar, and that's about it.
Is that 12 plus? A person's 18-34.
That's a good pickup line. It's rated. With a guy. You know, I got a 2.9 in my Starbucks.
Yeah,
my Starbucks performance rating.
Evaluation.
That'll get you something.
That falls right below, I have polyps on my cunt.
Do you know what that means, Patty?
Oh, look,
I think you're on the verge of a break. Something's going to happen for you.
Yeah.
A couple more presidents, you'll be in. Yeah.
You got that right.
Let me tell you how this is going to end.
Oh.
Some angry criminal robbing the register, holding her head under the coffee, and just fucking pouring scalding coffee on the side of her face.
Open the safe.
I don't know the number. They don't give it to us. It's about 3.8. I don't know the company.
How much do you make now with the raise?
Oh. Well, I make 970.
How much were you making?
875.
Wow.
95-cent raise?
They couldn't give you a buck raise? They had to go with 95 cents.
How about a buck?
That's a good one.
That's for the threes. That's for the perfect threes. They get a buck.
Quarter. So
you walk back in that fucking place and go, this place isn't called Star 95 Cents, asshole. I want a buck, you fucking cheapskate.
That's right.
Oh, I'm very happy. I really am. I'm very satisfied.
Well, she said most places give a 10 cent.
Not only that, but I got two retirement funds.
Hold on, where else have you worked? In fucking prison?
Yeah.
10 cents.
What do you mean you got two retirement funds?
Cutting cotton. I have a 401 with Fidelis.
8 cents
a
bushel.
And I also have a SIP fund, and now I even have a little stock.
You have a what fund?
I have a SIP fund, which is like they take money out of that and they buy stock for you.
Oh, boy. Great. And this wonderful guy that used to work at this place called Enron, he's running the funds.
No.
Nothing.
In 10 years, I'm going to do pretty good with the pension
and
everything.
In 10 years. What are you going to make in 10 years off the pension?
I have no idea. I don't know yet. I don't know how to calculate.
Have you ever thought of falling in love with a death row prisoner? I mean, there's usually something there, you know?
That's a good
one. Don't worry. There'll be a match for me someday.
Have you ever worked at any place in your entire life for 10 years?
Everything Yogurt for 25 years.
You were at Everything Yogurt for 25 years?
Well,
did you just say 25 years?
Oh, my God.
Well, actually, no. I started in 1980, and
I'm going to kill myself.
Now I just help my friend out in this franchise once in a while.
Did they give you a gold yogurt lid when you left?
No, they give you a chain. They give you a gold shotgun that you can point at yourself.
Oh, God.
I have an Employee of the Year plaque from 1986.
Apparently,
apparently, 1986
ran out though.
That's the year after I graduated high school. You were getting Employee of the Month.
Employee of the Month at fucking Everything Yogurt.
What happened? Oh, this country is a fucking giant, smelly vagina full of shitty people.
By the way, if I do the math, you were 31 in 86.
Yes, I was.
As Everything Yogurt getting
ago,
the Employee
sorry.
Of the Year.
What happened?
That
at Everything
was 20
yogurt.
Years ago this year.
Well, nothing happened. The company was changed over into other hands, and I just moved on. But I still help my friend out once in a while.
Where do you move on to?
Golden Gate Bridge.
Well, no. No, it's just been a change in partners.
Hold on.
There's nothing wrong with getting Employee of the Month at Everything Yogurt in 1986, but 20 years later, it's still the story you're telling.
Oh, yeah. Patty, Everything Yogurt, 25 years, and then what? What was the next move for you?
Well, after that, it was, I also worked in other jobs while I was at Everything Yogurt.
All right, but Everything Yogurt, 25 years, what was the next gig?
Burger King for...
That's a jump off.
I've worked at Nathan's,
You're just like one of those fucking ants that bring the cricket down into the hole, aren't you? You're just fucking food service industry. That's
anything you are. Anything Yogurt equals nothing life.
Yeah. Don't you think, like, that's 25 years of my fucking life, and what do you have to show for your 25 years at Everything Yogurt?
Did you get, besides the plaque,
any kind of, like, wow, you
estimate how much money you made in 25 years at Everything Yogurt?
No.
They said, look
at
our name. It's Everything Yogurt. We don't give you anything.
An hour in 1988.
How much?
I started off around $3 an hour, $3.50 an hour. The minimum wage was that low then.
And all the yogurt you could pump into your head, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. They don't give a shit. They just don't give a shit.
No.
Doesn't matter.
25 years, what is it?
Shit. Means nothing.
$3,000 for
equivalent
a life.
Equivalent to 50 18-year-old kids or 14-year-old kids who would have done the same thing. They don't care. They don't care.
Nah. Not at all.
She's a neglected American.
And she's moved on and on from that. McDonald's, this, and now she's just at Starbucks. And again, she's like, this is great, Starbucks. You know what's going to happen, Patty?
It's the first time I've ever
had benefits. But they're
taking
care of you, right?
Yes,
they
are. They're very good to their employees.
They're
real collective with my diet.
And you worked at Godoy for chocolates, too.
Yeah, I did.
That was my favorite job that you had, because she used to bring Godiva chocolates up.
She was a perfect employee for Godiva, and they kicked her out the door.
Why?
Because a change of managers, and the new manager didn't like me. Yeah. So.
Why? Well, how could he not like you?
No, I don't know. I probably knew too much.
All that fucked up shit going on at Godiva.
Right. Yeah, I knew
all
too much.
Fucking bullshit at Godiva.
See what the cherry-filled chocolates are made with.
Yes. Those are actually tiny miscarriages.
You know
actually,
too much.
More expensive than cherry chocolates, but the fucking owners.
The dumpster at Planned Parenthood with this ladle of fucking chocolate.
I'm telling everybody.
Yeah, I'm going to
get fired.
No one will listen to you.
It's a breaking story.
Hey, there's a job opening.
Go back to yogurt, you fucking...
There's a job opening in a bowling alley.
Yeah, I'm sure that's right.
No, thank you. I'm happy where I am.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think I'm going to retire at Starbucks.
Oh, 25 years of yogurt. What is that, some kind of sick joke?
I'm healthy. All right. Well, outside of my heart condition, I'm healthy.
Well,
the only thing I have to do is with my latest tests, I am developing osteoarthritis, which is common for my age, and I'm going to get therapy and do exercises for it.
How about some spermatozoa? Some protein from some fucking
You really
jizz.
Have nothing to lose, man.
Why aren't you getting any, like, sex? You've gone your whole life without sex. Don't you think that might help?
Yeah.
Mentally, physically, emotionally?
Yeah, when I meet the right person.
Right person. You're 51 right fucking years old. Who are you waiting for?
Just turn into a size queen.
Do you date? Do you date?
Size enjoy queen. The last
Do you date guys? 5 years.
I haven't had an opportunity to meet too many people.
No dates,
I don't go
no.
out very much. I go home. I watch my DVD.
Are you using that vibrator
computer.
We got you? Are you? Be honest.
I'm too embarrassed.
Oh, come on.
Yes. Oh, that's a yes.
How
right?
many times a week?
I'm embarrassed.
How many times
well,
a week?
Good, though. It's good you're doing
You're
that.
Using that? It's a good release, right?
I'm after having an orgasm.
It's a good release, right?
She probably
Attention.
Wore her clit away at this point.
Do you use any visual stimulation? Do you have any magazines around or pictures?
No, I don't want to buy that stuff because I don't know what the newspaper guy will think of me if I pick
oh,
it up.
Oh, God, enough.
The news, the savage at the... You're worried about the fucking savage at the newsstand worrying what the fuck... Oh,
fact,
my goodness.
I remember, let me tell you something. I don't know. I must look a little young for my age because I picked up a magazine
Please.
Once and the guy wanted to see my ID and I got embarrassed
no.
and ran
you
out.
You want to make sure you weren't retarded. Yeah. Human.
He wanted to see where you live so he could kill you.
Let me see ID. You
oh,
want Hustler?
No.
There you go.
That?
Take a Hustler. There's some cock in
she
there.
She needs guys. She needs like a, you know, Us magazine.
But there's cock Brad in there. Pitt.
Don't we have inches laying around?
That's what I was just going to say. We should get her inches.
Get one of Jimmy Norton's fag magazines.
Let me see.
Get, what's that one?
This is pretty good. Patty, look at this one. There's two cocks in this one.
Yeah.
Turn to page, this is Sasha Gray, Tommy Gunn, and Scott Nails. We all know their combo.
Yeah.
Turn to page,
sure.
66.
Turn to page 66, Patty, in your workbook.
Mm-hmm.
You could hold the mic in your mouth if you need
yeah,
to.
I'll hold the mic for you.
There you go. There she goes. Where'd you get the snazzy Pal Talk shirt? That's nice.
Oh, I got it from Happy Typing Girls' pajama party last May.
Oh, you were at the pajama party.
Yeah,
that's right.
I got one of the shirts.
You were the one that
Look
they
the
made
magazine.
Fun of.
Look at these two
no.
fellas. They
UD
got fedoras.
Drop out.
There's like a little story to this one. These two guys are interrogating a girl. They're like old-fashioned
private. Oh, my God. Yes, they do.
Like the 40s, like Bogart.
Yeah. What do you think of that, Patty?
The interrogator takes hold of a prisoner's garb right. and violently shakes the person around?
She's reading the words.
Read the text.
She's
the
reading the text.
What the fuck is that? That line could have come from a report at Guantanamo.
Turn the page. What do you think?
If you and your lady are into role playing,
what about the giant penises?
Come
turn
on,
the page, Patty.
Describe
the
what
page.
You're seeing.
There you go.
Turn the page.
Oh, turn that page.
She's Don't be embarrassed.
Into it. Like,
look at how big that is.
Why are you
Cape
embarrassed?
Skull in with a bedpan.
She giggles like it.
Fucking dope.
Oh, this is disgusting.
What's disgusting? You have so
no.
much guilt.
Yeah. No.
You have so much fucking Catholic
what is,
guilt in
look
you.
Look at it.
Hold on. What is disgusting about that? Yeah.
That one picture on the bottom of the page. Oh,
yeah,
it was
the girl sucking on a guy's cock.
Yeah.
One.
This
Yuck.
One.
What's describing?
She's in fucking
Describe
junior high.
Describe it.
She said doing something and there's something coming out and it's ew.
Oh, the money shot, huh?
Yuck.
A load of jizz.
The money shot. That's what it is. A money shot.
Patty, when you masturbate, what do you think of? If you're not thinking of
yeah.
like pictures like that,
I don't
a perfectly
know.
Brewed cup of coffee,
her plaque,
yeah,
her plaque,
just the plaque,
I don't
fucking
know.
Plaque.
I don't like the. Oh
Come
my
on.
God!
Which one would you like to be in?
Here's but I one thing I noticed.
Patty, your voice.
Oh, that
the
voice.
The guy in the pictures are losing their heart.
Voice.
You know, one thing I do notice with some of those girls when they,
they
do
just
that,
turn their heads in the pictures. What the fuck was that?
What?
I'm trying to
does
fuck a perfect hooker. Could you shut that off?
Their brains or something if they swallowed stuff. So I looked it up, and half, about three quarters of those girls have high IQs.
What? What?
You think?
Wait, wait. Patty heard. I think I heard her right. That when a girl like swallows.
Yeah, I
it affects
thought it
their
affected
brain?
Her
Smarter?
Brain, like she didn't, wasn't bright anymore or something.
Why did you think that?
Where'd you hear that?
I don't know.
Who told you that?
I have no idea. I don't remember. It just like
not far from the truth. It seems to be the dumb one. So no. You know, who told you that?
I don't know.
You heard that growing up?
That when I hear them being interviewed, they sound like they don't know too much. They don't read too much. You
and you think that
must be the jizz?
Yeah, it must be the jizz.
And you made the leap that it has to be the jizz.
It has to be the gallons of jizz. Can't be the crystal meth 10 minutes before.
Yeah, no kidding.
Or the fucking.
But then I read some kind of
beating dropped out of school at 13 because they were being fucked at home
by the teacher.
Those girls are actually in the gifted category. IQ wise, so
where'd you find this info out?
I don't know, some kind of a statistic.
Sex just for the emotional. You're not a complete human being. You have not done what human beings need to do to be complete humans.
Ah,
I know one thing. The last time I went down to AC was back in June. And the guy at the desk that was giving out the comp tickets wanted to, you know, wanted me to come down sometime and go for coffee with
him. Why didn't you go?
Why don't you go to you like
What's
him?
Wrong with you?
I don't know. I'm still in touch with him. So if, when
How
I
are you in touch with him?
Again,
the fucking shy bit and fuck someone already.
You know, he's a nice guy.
What are you waiting for?
Well, I'm going to wait until the 27th. Because I was invited to
fucking
a free slot tournament.
Do it already.
A
what?
A free slot tournament. If you win, you get a little money, you know? And
You're
they
never
only
gonna
give it
do
to
it.
Card holders. And I have a card for the last 4 years, even though I don't go very often. But
oh
I still get
God.
The
Keep the card, though, you know? It only takes a little room in your
How
wallet.
How great would it
so
be, though?
So what I'll do is, he's probably working that night, so I'll go down and have coffee with him.
Where's Richard Speck when you need him? Fuck someone already.
I'll have coffee with him.
Wouldn't that be great?
Start with a coffee's a good start, but you haven't had the coffee yet.
Coffee with him. He was a nice guy.
Well, I'll make it a point to go down and
when you're 68.
You know, hang with
how do you? Yeah.
No, on the 27th.
You've had 30
October,
years of
I'm
coffee. You need a fucking penis.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You've had your whole
well,
fucking
you start
life.
With coffee, yeah. You know, I just want to get to know him.
Start
sure.
Coffee
nice
at 51.
And, you know, and he likes me. You know, a
he
lot.
Doesn't. How great would it
person.
Be after the first cup of coffee if she's forced to eat his oniony ass at gunpoint in an alley?
No, I really can tell.
You gotta jump on it because you're gonna show up on the 27th. I'm ready for coffee, and he's gonna go, "Who the fuck are you?"
Yeah, he
I tossed aside an invitation 6 months ago, and you show up now looking like that? Are you kidding me?
I'm looking at another girl rubbing his unclipped cock through his workman's overalls, his coveralls.
Oh my God.
Paint and child blood on them.
Get down there now. Now. Every second that you're not blowing that guy. Fucking
right
waste of your
wait
life.
Until the 27th. Patty,
he's been through the
invitation.
He's been through 50 girls already. That's what he does. He's been through 50 of them already. He's not going to fucking remember you like his princess walking in.
He does remember me. He's called me.
You have
me
no
once
time.
Twice.
Look, at this point in your life, if you blow 1,000 guys, you're still a loser.
You're behind schedule.
You're still way behind.
Yeah, he has called me, you know, to chat with me on the phone and stuff.
Chat
you know
on the phone? Mm-hmm. What, did he crank the handle?
Chat.
No one chats on a phone anymore.
Operator,
you know?
Caldonia 647.
Hello, Sarah. Could you connect me to the guy that gives away the comp cards right away? Number, please.
How fuck old are you?
Yeah, he knows I'm coming down the 27th.
You know, 27th. Good. She's got it scheduled like a missile launch date.
Okay. You know, he just works
a fucking cup of coffee, you dolt.
You know, he takes his break, and we'll have a cup of coffee in one of the restaurants.
Right. Excellent plan.
Wow, that's
an excellent plan.
What an awful. This guy thinks cup of coffee means what I think it means.
Right.
Which is meet me in my apartment and suck or you get punched.
No.
I hope it ends in fireworks or a shallow grave for all of us here. All you see is one of those three-quarter leg pant legs just sticking out of the fucking dirt.
Oh, my God.
With a fucking shoe and a broken foot. I'm kidding, of course.
I hope he gets right through with you. I hope he gets through with you and your cock looks like it's covered with espresso grounds.
Yeah. Yes, I tripped, Jim.
You said your cock, meaning her.
Her cock. Oh, she probably got a cock. Yeah. Who knows?
Oh, she looked at me all mean. Well, like, no, I don't have a cock.
But what was that, Patty? Do you have a cock?
Do you have a cock?
She doesn't know.
No,
she's never
I
opened
don't.
Her pants.
You know I don't.
All right,
how
Patty.
Do we, we have seen her completely naked, by the way.
Really?
She put on a Krusty the Clown mask.
She's
something with masks on the show. We're like the Mardi Gras.
And she jerked me off wearing... She put on deli gloves and jerked me off.
Yeah, she put on deli gloves and jerked off Jimmy. She
Is that true?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Put on a clown mask and got completely naked and crawled through mouse traps to get checks so she could pay her rent. She's done a lot for us.
And I played with her nipples while she played with herself with a vibrator.
And we put a vibrator in her panties.
The fuck is...
All right.
Yeah, I know. It makes no sense.
You know something?
But don't put a dick in there.
No, keep the cock set. She's also...
Jerk off Jimmy with deli gloves on the radio. But still waiting for the nice, for the right guy.
Had her bare hand
dick in the pussy.
Down the front of Ron Jeremy's pants.
Yeah.
Under his ball bag. And let Ron Jeremy put his hand down the front of her pants.
Uh-huh.
But... She's a bird.
Don't put the dick in the pussy.
Cup of coffee
on the
27th. And then hopefully by 2009 we'll be up to, you know, him
after
combing my hair.
But I'll bet he's hearing this, and why would he want to go out with a girl that's done those things?
Yeah, you slut.
Because she's famous. She's on her own AIDS. Great show.
But he probably thinks you're a nice girl, and now he knows that you're playing with Ron's balls, and you're jerking off, and you're like your nipples played with, and you're a vibrator whore.
All right, Patty.
All right, Patty.
Good luck, Patty.
We got enough comedy out of you.
We're lost.
We're done with you now.
It was nice meeting you. You seem very happy. You seem like
she
a well-balanced, settled person.
Thank you.
All this deflects off you because you have an inner happiness.
Yes.
Oh, but still, you should let some guy fuck you in the pussy.
Yeah. Or at least...
Really?
Well, at least, and I don't mean to be crass, but let some black man use your mouth as a pocket pussy.
go with God. Let someone fuck you, you idiot.
All right, it is time for line of the day.
Damn, Louis fits right in.
Absolutely, Louis. Just,
not even
I'm not
an
like
effort.
This. It's just this.
Not even an
about
effort.
This room is horrible.
It is. It really is.
It really is.
Because we leave. You know, Billy Burr.
Sure.
Bill Burr. There are so many times he'll sit right there and we'll just go through a show and the same shit's happening today. Mm-hmm. And then we get out on the street and walk to our cars and he'll do nothing but go, God, it just felt fucking terrible.
Yeah, I know.
The poor fucking girl and the thing. And then we're just fucking saying shit to her. And I'm like, Billy, shut the fuck up. I got to do that every day.
Right.
You know, and I got to sleep at night.
Don't make us think
don't
too much.
Don't fucking guilt me out because
no,
you can't fucking deal
leave
with it.
No.
Yeah, go home, curl up in the fetal position in your shower. Yeah,
exactly.
You
take your rape shower. Leave me
take
out.
No, take it.
Take your rape
Here's a rape kit. Swab your pussy. Give it to the police and go home.
Go get some coffee.
Sit in the tub until the water is all frigid and cold.
Oh, my God. Cry yourself to sleep, faggot.
All right.
Oh, man.
Line of the day, sponsored by BoneDogFight.com. Log on and watch American fighters battle for the right to represent the U.S. in a bout against the Russians. It's all on BoneDogFight.com, a mixed martial arts tournament and docu-reality unlike any seen before.
I personally don't even know how one was picked today.
It was tough.
Well, they were flying all over the place.
Well, there were some great lines at the end of the show, but I think the competition ended before 11, so just keep that in mind.
What a rip-off.
Because they had to get it together.
Don't count any lines out.
Oh, okay. Don't count any
really?
Lines out. You know something? Because Otto had one. That was very fucking funny. I don't know. Let's see what the judges said.
Well, we got
very competitive
How
here.
How did this get who judges this?
Yeah.
Guys behind the scenes.
Our morons.
Yeah.
Here we have moron Alfresco and moron Under Glass is over here. But they judge it.
Mm-hmm.
Shut up. Don't fucking use ventriloquism back there to call me an asshole without moving your lips.
We got three runner-ups today.
Wow.
Three runner-ups today.
Wow.
That means it was a pretty damn good show.
Mm.
Here's the first runner-up for line of the day.
Yeah.
I always don't measure, like, I think you can measure how bad a person you are by how soon you masturbated after the planes hit. Like, what's the first time?
Before
was it like a month after?
That's a good gauge.
Between the two buildings collapsing, yeah. Probably a bad sign that I had to, because otherwise they win, you know, the terrorists.
Right.
Wow, there you go.
There you go. Runner up the show.
Oh, made
the runner up.
Louis C.K. with a runner up. Let's do the second runner up for line of the day.
It's one of those things, like, they don't usually just have them laying around.
Well, he was probably going in there to fix a toilet. There was a toilet full of diarrhea and shit and tampons that he was fixing.
Oh, so you think he.
So they went in there and they improvised.
Guy.
They found, they said, hey, let's use what he's using.
Oh. Or they just saw the retarded man walking to the bathroom with the snake, and the one guy went, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Oh, my God.
That was awesome. That was awesome.
Wow.
And the one guy said, yeah. And then he goes, and as he's holding the guy down, putting it in his ass, the other guy's like, I just thought he wanted to turn the lights off and run. I didn't know we were going to rape another man. Mentally disabled.
You know what line of the day is like? It's like those old sitcoms that plays the still the picture during the episode.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, you'll have the Fonz doing a little pose by the car or something.
Very good, Jimmy. All right, the final runner-up line of the day. Here it is.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow. Would you like to be in here?
But I, one thing I noticed.
Out of your voice.
Oh, that
the
voice.
The guys in the pictures are losing their heart on voice.
You know, what I do notice with some of them.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That was last minute.
Another one from Jimmy. Finally, here is today's line of the day.
Here.
Line of the day.
When your husband goes food shopping and puts the groceries away, does he have to hire a rodeo clown to distract you?
Otto, yes. George, yeah. Line of the day.
Yeah, that easy. One. That one was killer, man.
Yeah. Otto will be at Comics tonight.
Yes.
On 14th Street here.
And in Freehold tonight. Tomorrow, and go to ottoandgeorge.com if you have a computer.
There you go.
And Otto's working with Nina Hartley. She's just not that, I don't know, like, she's got a book out called Total Sex, and she's doing a Borders signing on Wall Street today at Borders. If you want to meet her, she's a porn legend.
Yeah.
You know, if you want to meet her, she's there this afternoon.
She's there.
And Louis
C.K.
Louis. Tomorrow night, a great stand-up, obviously. At
Saturday night.
Trump Marina.
Nice.
Oh, Otto's tomorrow, Friday. I'm sorry. And Louis Saturday.
Saturday.
Yeah.
I'm also doing a taping.
Yeah, we're so used to it being a Friday with this.
Tonight is comics.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, it is. Okay.
All right, tonight is comics for Otto.
Tomorrow, Freehold Freehold Sheridan.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yes.
And you're taping something?
Oh, well, I'm doing an HBO hour for the first time.
Yeah.
It's taping in L.A. at the Henry Fonda Theater. I know you guys aren't there, but somewhere. I'm for X. Awesome. You are, so.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Some people show up.
November 4th.
Want to look at the loons.
Yeah, dope. And get lost.
Louis, it was a pleasure.
Louis,
thanks, guys.
Amazing,
thanks for having
man.
Me.
Great day.
I
great
had a
time.
Great time.
Louis' first appearance in studio. He
that's
killed.
My favorite radio time ever I ever
knocks
had.
It out of the park.
Seriously,
man.
That was great.
Come back and see us.
Fits in all too well.
And I have, I have a couple of plugs. One is that my New Year's Eve Borgata tickets go on sale.
I'm going.
I know you are. We have to call and get you a room immediately.
Better. Kenny's getting them.
Okay,
Kenny better
ahead.
Be on it.
He's on it.
He's nice with the smoothies and the fruit, but if I fucking end up holding my dick in front of the motel there, I'm going to be pissed.
Yes. That is Saturday, 10 a.m. on Ticketmaster. They go on sale for the Borgata. It's not the big room that I did with David Tell, the event center. This is the music box.
Oh, it's an intimate atmosphere.
Well, I know it's a good room, but there's going to be less tickets than there were last time, so if you want to go, and the Hammerstein, the 10th of November.
I'm also joining Jimmy in Denver.
Yeah, you can, Anthony and I are going to the same place next week.
Just going to hang out.
Yeah.
Couple
week
of
tomorrow.
Couple of men
in Jimmy, Denver.
We'll see Jimmy Monday, San Francisco.
Yeah, man, you guys
have
the guy
today.
I'm fucking jumping to watch it on the flight. If I can get my copy before we leave, I want to watch that on the flight.
Well, if you're up, call us tomorrow to talk about it, because I'm seeing the movie tonight as well, The Bridge.
I will be up. I'm doing radio out there.
Yeah, all right. Give us a call tomorrow morning, Jimmy.
All right.
Wow, what can I say? We had a great time. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Later, bye.
Starting to get hot.
Oh.
You know, I'm starting to get hot.
Oh, no. I'm going to give up my virginity.
I'm a sport.
Maybe take a little cock right into my mouth.
It must hurt.
Maybe take it in the rear.
Maybe bang me up the ass.
Patty, Patty, Patty.
That's what they call me.
Patty, Patty,
Patty. She's a freak.
Patty, Patty, Patty.
That's what they call me.
Patty.
She's a freak. What do you want me to do? I'm gonna be facing the wall. What do you want me to do? I've always wanted a juicy cock. Put it between the boobs. I'm into the TFing. Put it between the boobs. Put it in the pits. Put it in the pits. My favorite oral treat. My favorite eating cock.